As we all know that we are more dependent on online processes since the onset of this pandemic. Further, effective communication and presentation skills are very important for every individual. Whether someone is an IT professional, management professional, or any other professional, communication and presentation skills are important for everyone. Our communication skills define our growth in professional as well as our personal life. That is why it is more important for us to enhance our skills for better online presentation and communication. This webinar is very special because today we'll learn how to communicate more efficiently at work to achieve organizational goals. It's a pleasure and honor for us that we have some very eminent, distinguished, and knowledgeable personalities with us who would help us in developing powerful and effective online presentation and communication. So, without taking much time of our audience, now I would like to introduce our first speaker of the day, Dr. Babita Kataria. Nothing is better than learning from the experts. Dr. Kataria is the Director of University Industry Interface Cell of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam University, Lucknow. Her key responsibilities include overseeing and managing corporate activities for recruitment. I'm sorry for the disturbance. So, I am introducing Dr. Kataria. Her key responsibilities include overseeing and managing corporate activities for recruitment, especially campus hiring for engineering, management, and various other programs offered by the university and its affiliated institutes. She has 26 years of experience in the field of medical sciences, administration, business development, training, and placements. She has done her doctorate in the management from Guru Gobind Singh Infrastructure University, Delhi. She has been recently awarded by the Circle of Legends among top 20 international women with nobility and courage. Now, I would like to invite Dr. Kataria to take over the session. Dr. Kataria.
Good morning. To all the students, first of all, and to the, I think the director, ma'am, is like for important person from this institute. So I really thank you to the management, to the director, and all the faculty members, and especially to Pratima for inviting me on this platform of your college. So that I can just meet all the students digitally, because these are the days where we can meet the students digitally only. And we have just seen that one of the dearest students has welcomed me with a very nice video of Modi ji and Rahul ji. So I'm very happy that people are so aware of. And thank you so much for the invitation. And I hope I can immediately start my session of my presentation, because we have already late for 20 minutes and due to some technical glitch. So should I, I'm allowed to share my screen?
Yes, ma'am, please go ahead.
I hope you can see my first screen.
Yes, ma'am, it is visible.
Give me a second. So today's topic we have given you have given us for the communication skill, the presentation of best communication skills, and definitely how we should be very effective during our communication skills. So I preferably one of my dear student, I think I can see Anil is there. Anil is a student or he's a faculty from the institute?
Dr. Anil Singh is a member of faculty.
Okay, any student you can tell me?
Archie,
can you if you are been allowed to mute your system and you can speak out. So can you, because I really like to have an interactive session. I cannot have one way session. So that is also a part of communication skills, but definitely I like, because it is a interactive session, then I would love to interact with the students also. If Farhad can speak, or any one student, just tell me, what do you mean by communication?
Ma'am, communication means to interact with someone, to talk, to share something with someone.
So Archie, first of all, when we have started, you should introduce yourself to me, that I am Archie from this department, and I'm studying in second year or first year of management or engineering or wherever you're studying. So then you should have started your communication. So then we would have made a bond and our effective communication skills would have started. That yes, we know how to communicate with each other. We first introduce ourselves and then we start our communication. So this is the first lesson of my presentation. Now we will go ahead. So our topic is effective communication skills. And thank you, Archie, for giving me the definition of communication. It is perfectly right. And then we will move that it's the communication skills are the key to success. So we have given a live example why this quote has been given. Good communication skills are the key to success. So I hope all the students have understood why we should have an effective communication skills. So we have a chat box, because I think you people are not allowed much to you unmute yourself. So there is a chat box from where we can communicate to each other. So wherever you feel that you want some more depth of it, I will just explain you, because I don't want to make it a bored session. I want it to be a enthusiastic session, and let's start it up. So what are my objectives for today? My objectives are define and understand communication, the communication process, barriers in communication process, types of communication, means of communications, tips to improve verbal and non-verbal communication. Just tell me, when I'm reading the objectives, do you like my speed? This speed should be there, or the speed should be like, it should be less, or it should be in between, on the middle, medium pace. What type of speed should I have? This much is fine, so that I can cover the topic. Anybody can answer? Any student? Because faculty knows. I really like if can one of the students should write to me. Okay, I feel that it is fine, and because I just questioned you, because I need the answer, because this is also a part of effective communication. What type of speed you should have, how you should explain yourself, how you should say something, whether it if you see my words, if it is like mumbling, if I'm doing communication process, so it is wrong. So I have to be very, very clear. My speech should be like that, which is very soothing to somebody's ear. It is completely clear words, which I can recognize what she's saying or somebody is saying, and I can understand. Then it is help to understand what the person who is putting a question is asking, so that you can give a proper answer. So this is how we should be very, very clear, and what I can say, it should be a clear communication from your side. Fine. So these are my objectives, which I will be covering in this presentation today. So now it is what is communication? So Archie has given a very good definition, and I think you can read communication is the transmission of an idea or feeling, feeling, so that the sender and the receiver share the same understanding. Communication is not a mysterious process. It takes place when the ideas from your mind are transferred to another's and arrive intact, complete, and coherent. So for example, in just see the previous two slides, I have started from one's first slide and I've started my teaching. What is communication? What is effective communication? So I wanted to interact you. I wanted to tell you about the topic we are talking about, what objectives we'll be taking covering in this particular thing, in particular presentation. It should be coherent. It should be complete. It should be intact. Whatever the ideas I wanted to give it to you during my whole presentation. So importance of communication, we have talked about express thoughts, ideas, and feelings, creating awareness to fulfill our goal, avoid isolation, highlight issues, progress development, educating the masses. So I hope these points are clear. What is the importance of the communication? Anybody can speak out? Farah?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am, it's clear. Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning. So now, what is the communication process? Question I wanted to ask, whether I should carry on my presentation in complete English or it can be English, combination of Hindi and English. Whatever you like, I can proceed with that. Or Farah, you can tell me. Well, people will be very good.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. It's fine, ma'am. It's fine.
Total and my English voice. Okay, my voice.
Yes,
my
ma'am. Everything is clear. Yes.
Okay, everything is yes. So we are talking about the communication process. What is communication process? So I am a sender, you are a receiver. What is there? I am a sender, you are a receiver. But there can be number of barriers in between. And there are some resources which are required to take this message to you. For example, when I'm talking to you, so I'm sending some data to you. I'm sending some communication to you. What are the mediums in between? The mediums are wireless, the medium is digital, and there are so many major medium is, what is the major medium in between? Anybody can tell? Rest of it, Archie and Farah, anybody else can speak out? What is the medium in between any communication? अगर हमारे पास तारे ना हो, हमारे पास नेटवर्क ना हो, हमारे पास कुछ और ना हो, तो हमारा क्या मीडियम होता है एक दूसरे से बात करने का? आवाज?
मैम, इट्स लैंग्वेज. आई थिंक इट्स लैंग्वेज.
ओके. एंड
कॉन्फिडेंस.
ओके. नो मीडियम. आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट मीडियम. कॉन्फिडेंस इज अ एडजेक्टिव. इट इज अ
मैम, इट्स आवर वॉइस.
सो आई थिंक आई विल एक्सप्लेन.
मैम, आवर जेस्चर्स, हाउ वी प्रेजेंट आवर जेस्चर्स.
वेरी नाइस. एंड आल्सो देयर इज इन बिटवीन एयर. यस, दिस इज द राइट. शिवानी, यू आर एब्सोल्युटली राइट. Air is in between. When I'm standing in front of you, it's you are air. Standing in front of me. There is a air where we use our vibrations, and this is the media from where the language is being sent from one code to the other person. So one thing is that. Then now, because I am connected to you, you are in Kanpur, I am in Delhi, so we are connected through mediums, different mediums. There is a medium, that is the wireless medium. Then what is the barrier? What are the barriers? For example, when we have started, sir has welcomed me, and during his welcome, there a video came, which is not relevant in between, because at that time the communication is going on. He is welcoming me and I am listening and all other people are listening. So these are the barriers. So which hindered his voice, and he has to kept quiet. And after he has, the girl Mansi has stopped that video, then immediately sir has started. So these are different barriers, and barriers can be anything. The voice, it can be breakage, it can be anything. It can be a loose network, it can be a weak network, it can be anything. So these are the barriers. So this is how the communication process. I hope I am very, very clear, because I will be telling you in a very short, because I have to tell so many things to you. So this is the communication process we are using it. Now, so we are talking about the barrier of communication. So we have told you, I have told you, noise, inappropriate medium, assumptions, misconceptions, emotions, language differences, cultural differences, poor listening skills, use of jargons, distractions. So these are the different barriers which are making our communication not proper, or it is not complete, it is not coheriting us, it is not connecting us. So there is a problem. Then cultural difference over here, it is written because there may be you speak Hindi, I speak English, and we are not able to exchange our thoughts because of language barrier. So these are the different barriers. And what type of communications are there? One-way communication, that is a storytelling. So somebody is telling story and everybody is listening. So what is our communication? What you will call this presentation as, which one it is? It is a one-way communication, or it is a two-way communication, or it is a one-to-many communication? Tell me.
One to many communication.
Or I will give you all these three examples with my presentation. So tell me, is it two way? It is not two way.
Yes, ma'am, it is two way.
It is two way. I am asking the question, you are telling me the answer. So it is a two way. It is a one way. If I will say nobody will speak, not to mute yourself, unmute yourself. I will only speak, you will not going to speak in between. So what it will be? It is one way. So other example of one way, two way, one to many in my class. What are the examples? Anybody can tell me? Except this Farhad, Ayushi, Anusha is there, Shivani is there. Any others, dear student? Tell me. Patawat, jaldi, time bahut bhag raha hai, jaldi. What is one-way communication? Whenever we are doing some seminars, workshop, just I will give you a clue. You have to map it. What is seminar? Is it a one-way? It is a two-way? It is one-to-many? Come. Ruby, tell me. Ruby, Shivani, anyone? Come. What is seminar? Is it a one-way? It is two-way or one-to-many?
One-way, ma'am.
One way.
One to many.
And it can be one to many also?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. So what is a workshop? Is it two way? It is one way or one to many?
Two-way.
In tino mein wo ek hi hai sirf. I'll give you the clue.
One to many.
No.
Two way, ma'am.
It is two
way. One way communication.
It is two way. Yes, the one who has given the answer, it is two way. Because you are doing in workshop, you do some practical, you do something with the person who is giving you a learning. So it is always a two way communication. Okay, what is argument? Is it two way? It is one way or is one to many?
And it's two way.
It is two way. Wow. So very nice. So I think I have told you about types of communication. Now you will never forget in your life what is type of communication is. So now we are talking about, then again, there are different types. How we can depict, how we can say. Already we have in our question answers, I have cleared it out, what I mean it. So interpersonal communication, that is communication between two or more people called interpersonal communication. So we can talk that, yes, we people are talking. It is an interpersonal communication. What is this? It is saying intrapersonal. Sometimes we sit aside and we think, oh, what I have done that time? Oh, I have not learned. Oh, during that time, I would have learned. So I would have given a very good exam. So it is an intra. When you're talking to yourself. When you're talking to yourself, it is called intra. When you are talking to one to other person, it is inter. So for example, you say, intra competition in the departments, intra department competition. Intra means in your own department you have a competition, but if you say inter department, then it will goes to one department is management, one is engineering, one is pharmacy. So this is communication in between. There is a competition in between, that is inter communication. Mayank, you have to mute yourself. Mayank, please. So there is one more, extra personal communication. Extra, what is that? Communication between human beings and non-human entities. That is, you are talking to a pets, you are talking to animals. When you communicate with them, when you will see that if you have a pet, a dog is there, he will come and you will just pat him. So all these things are this. So what is group communication? That is, you do GD, group discussions. That is, it comes under this category. Fine. Are you able to understand? Anyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
I hope there is no difficulty for understanding.
No, ma'am.
Then we talk about mass communication. So we are talking, this is the right example when you are talking to each other on this digital platform, and we are understanding what is communication skills, what is effective communication skills. It is a mass communication I'm talking about, or you can say the journals, books, newspapers, everything. It is a mass. When it is going to mass people, when you are talking about news, it is going to everyone. It is a broadcasting. So the wherever the broadcasting is, that is a mass communication. Now we'll talk about means of communication. So it can be verbal and it can be non-verbal. So for example, in the previous slides, we have talked about one way, two way, multiple, one to mass, something like that. What is that? It is verbal or non-verbal?
Ma'am, verbal.
Open.
And we're talking about when we talk up to the pet, we are talking about our pets, a dog, cat, or something like that. What is that? That is a non-verbal or verbal?
Non-verbal.
Okay, very nice. So it is a right answer. Now I was showing you one video for the verbal, because वैसे भी इतना सुनने के बाद तो वैसे ही कोई बोर हो जाएगा. तो at least we should have some video, and very good video I have, and for the verbal part. So just to enjoy and just take a break in between. So this is a organization, Pink Jaguar Entertainment, which is bringing a biopic for you people on Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam ji, jo ki hamare unseen leader hai of this university. Or so I have just brought it for you people so that you can. So I think there is some wait. You're able to listen?
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
Voice is not coming.
I hope you understand what is the type of, it is not speaking anything. It is not saying anything, but it is a communication. Through it, we came to know that is a biopic of Dr. Abdul Kalam ji, has been in a process of making. So we will be very soon, we will be seeing biopic of Abdul Kalam ji. And I'm so happy that under his unseen leadership, I'm working. I have worked with this university. So I'm now a former director also of this university. So a definition of verbal communication is referred to the form of communication in which message transmitted verbally communication is done by word, mouth, and a piece of writing. Object, written objects of objective of every communication is to have people understood why we are trying to, what we are trying to convey. So this is how we wanted to, whatever we wanted to communicate, it is through verbal communication. So what I'm speaking, it is all verbal communication. Now, parts of verbal communication. Verbal communication has oral and written forms. And it can be like in oral communication, spoken words are used. It includes face-to-face conversations, speech, telephonic conversations, video, radio, television, voice, over internet. In oral communication, communication is influenced by pitch, volume, speed, and clarity of speaking. So I hope during all my previous slides, we are covering all these things because I want in the last you have impact. When we say number of times one thing, it puts an impact on our mind. So I wanted to put an impact. Every one slide will speak about communication. What is the actual requirement of communication? How it should impact yourself? How it should always learn that one person, whatever it he or she has spoken out. So why it happened that many of the things have been remembered by you when what you have studied in first, you do not remember all the things, but the main thing which is required, you remember today also, that is the learning of alphabets, learning, making of sentences. So communication ka aisa impact hona chahiye jo lifelong rahe. So communication itni aapki strong honi chahiye oral. Similarly, we should have a very strong written in communication. You people, after this, I think you are in final year, so you will be moving to your jobs very soon. So over there, we require emails, we require application, we require letters, we require some reports to be generated. So agar aapki written communication abhi theek nahi hogi, to aap theek se properly apne aap ko express nahi kar paoge. To uske liye hame kya kya chahiye? Uske liye hame sentence making aani chahiye, uske liye hame hamari vocabulary strong honi chahiye, uske liye hamare paas grammar honi chahiye. Hame acha acha kuch apne aajkal to bahut zamana hai us cheez ka, kya bolte hain usko, blogs writing ka. कंटेंट राइटिंग, ब्लॉग राइटिंग, इसके ऊपर बहुत काम हो रहा है. तो आपको भी उस चीज का ध्यान रखना पड़ेगा बिकॉज वेरी सून यू आर मूविंग टू इंडस्ट्री, यू आर गोइंग टू डू योर जॉब्स. सो अगर आपकी रिटन कम्युनिकेशन ठीक नहीं, यू कैन नॉट एबल टू एक्सप्रेस. और रिटन इंग्लिश का बहुत बड़ा मायना है बिकॉज अवर इंडियन सोसाइटी, इंडियन इंडस्ट्री जो है हमारे, बहुत ज्यादा वी आर बेस्ड ऑन सर्विस इंडस्ट्री. और सर्विस इंडस्ट्री नीड्स हाई लेवल ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन, वेदर इट इज ओरल और इट इज रिटन. So when you're writing a mail, you have to very, very be cautious about writing your mail. अभी बच्चा कहता है कि भाई मैंने तो मैं बोल नहीं पा रहा हूँ इंग्लिश में. अरे भाई, since childhood, that is from KG till 12th, and then after 12th, your education, graduation and masters, you are studying in English, you are writing in English, but you are not able to speak. Why? बिकॉज हमारा घर का एनवायरमेंट नहीं है. हमने अपने कॉलेज में भी वो एनवायरमेंट नहीं रखा है. हम लोग बात कर रहे हैं हिंदी में, बात कर रहे हैं, पढ़ा रहे हैं हिंदी में, पढ़ा रहे हैं. मैं भी पढ़ा रही हूँ. आई एम नॉट अ एडवोकेट ऑफ इंग्लिश. मेरे को तो अपनी हिंदी बहुत पसंद है और मैं बहुत अच्छी हिंदी बोलती हूँ, मुझे मालूम है. लेकिन ये है कि अगर हमारी एक इंडस्ट्री की रिक्वायरमेंट है, इट इज टू अर्न अ ब्रेड एंड बटर, वी रिक्वायर इंग्लिश बिकॉज आर इंडस्ट्री इज रिलाइंग ऑन इंग्लिश. तो आपकी वोकैबुलरी, people say that I have no vocabulary, I am very, very low in vocabulary. So why you have not studied? So aaj hi aap ek lagaiye apna ek board pe ya apne ghar ki ek wall pe lagaiye ki main har din 4 words sikhunga, yaad karunga every word, uska meaning, uska synonym aur uska antonym. So kya hoga, aap ek word ke 4 word yaad kar rahe हैं कि वो सिनोनिम है, दैट मींस 5 वर्ड्स हो गए. उसका आपने एंटोनियम याद किया, इसका लाना छठा वर्ड. तो नाउ जस्ट आपने कोशिश करी कि मैं दिन में 3 ही वर्ड सीखूंगा, तो 3 6 18 18 वर्ड्स आपने एक दिन में सीखे. तो अब आप लगाइए कि अगर फर्स्ट क्लास से लेके अब मास्टर्स तक, जहाँ के 12 और 3 15 और 2 17 क्लासेस के अंदर अगर आप इसको 17 सालों को मल्टीप्लाई बाय 365 डेज इनटू दीस 6 वर्ड्स, देन हाउ मेनी वर्ड्स यू माइट हैव लर्न्ड इन द होल लाइफ ऑफ 17 इयर्स ऑफ योर एजुकेशन. सो दिस इज हाउ यू कैन इम्प्रूव ऑन योर वोकैबुलरी. एंड इफ वोकैबुलरी इज गुड, आई एम डेड श्योर योर राइटिंग स्किल्स विल बी वेरी गुड, योर ओरल स्पीकिंग शुड बी वेरी गुड. Will be very good. Not should be, will be very good. Now we come to the part non-verbal. Pratima ma'am, wherever I have to stop, please do let me know. Because when I start with my classes, I never remember my time. So it is, I'm really sorry if I'm exceeding. So please tell me. So I will just shorten it out, my speaking. So now we are talking about non-verbal. So again, a small video. Kyunki bore ho gaye hain hum. मेरी बातें सुन के
तो की वडियां तेरियां मेरे साथ, की वडियां तेरियां मेरे साथ गुरु जीओ, की वडियां.
जस्ट डोंट लिसन दिस पब्लिक, देखो डेफिनेटली ये एक बहुत अच्छा भजन है. इसमें आप भजन को ना देखिए, जो हम नॉन वर्बल की बात कर रहे हैं उसको सोचिएगा कि मैं नॉन वर्बल इसमें से वीडियो में से क्या दिखा. मैंने कोशिश करी साउंड को हटाने की बट मेरे से हटी नहीं, तो फिर मैंने बोला कि चलो इस बहाने ही सही भगवान का नाम भी ले लेंगे. तो वी स्टार्टेड कि भी ये कम्युनिकेशन भी ये इंपैक्ट भी होना
चाहिए. फकर अवल फकीर तू है, आसा भी तू वीर तू है, रूदास सरीर तू है, सब भैणा दा वीर तू है, शुरू भी तू अखीर तू है. वाह गुरु वाह, 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 गुरु. गुरु वाह, गुरु वाह, गुरु वाह, गुरु. हर तन वस्त्र
So over here, if you have seen, I just talked about non-verbal. So non-verbal, what you will say, Archie, can you just explain this video? What it he or the one who has made this video wanted to tell?
Yes, ma'am. I think that this video taught us that anybody and everybody can teach us anything. Like we should always be ready. And we should be ready to get knowledge from everyone. Animals are also teaching us something good here.
Okay, fine. It is like that. But when we are talking about non-verbal, over here, see, there are different animals. And they have different type of language. They cannot communicate with each other. But their feeling, their support to each other, जो उन्होंने एक दूसरे को संभाला, एक दूसरे को अपने पर उसने अपने पर बिठा लिया, अपने सब कुछ कर लिया, उसको प्यार कर रहा है, तो जो विदाउट उन्होंने अपनी किसी भी तरह की लैंग्वेज, विच गाय कायों का बकरी का नहीं समझ रही या मुर्गी का नहीं समझ, लेकिन उसके बावजूद भी दे कैन कम्युनिकेट विद ईच अदर, दे कैन रिलाय, दे कैन अंडरस्टैंड वॉट. वो उससे डर के नहीं भाग रहा, वो उसके पास आ रहा है, उसके पास मिल रहा है. सो वॉट इज दिस? दिस इज अ नॉन वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन, जो हम इशारों से, प्यार से, विदाउट टच से, दीज आर ऑल नॉन वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन. सो अगेन थ्रू साइंस एंड सिंपल्स, विच आई हैव टोल्ड यू बाई दिस वीडियो, बिकॉज आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू रन. we can skip some of the few slides, because from that video I want to depict all these things. So signs and symptoms, when you are moving on the roads, you have some symbols of hospital. You will come to know that after 1 kilometer there is a hospital, or there can be like a passerby passway. So these are the symbols. Through symbols and signs we can teach, we can communicate. So types of normal communication, non-verbal communication. So this is kinesis, that is a body language, haptics, touch language, proxemics, space language, artifacts, facts, environmental, chronemics, time language, silence, sign, paralanguage, vocalic. These are different types of normal, non-verbal communication. So अब हम बॉडी लैंग्वेज की बात करते हैं. तो जब हम फेशियल एक्सप्रेशन हैं, हम कहते हैं ना उसकी बॉडी लैंग्वेज ऐसी थी कि भाई हमें पता चल रहा था ही इज वेरी एरोगेंट. तो कैसे पता चलता है कि उसका स्टाइल होगा, उसने हाथ कस के पकड़े हुए होंगे, बड़े उसके फेस पे ऐसे एक्सप्रेशन होंगे कि भाई इस बंदे से तो बात ही नहीं कर सकते. सो दिस इज लाइक दिस आर डिफरेंट बॉडी. एक होता है बहुत प्यार से उसने काम से, हाँ ये बताइए आपको क्या हेल्प चाहिए, क्या सपोर्ट चाहिए, अरे अरे वो पता है वो बहुत अच्छी टीचर थी हमारी, बड़े प्यार से बात करती थी. क्यों? तो उनकी जो बॉडी लैंग्वेज है दैट इज अ पार्ट, वो आप में कम्युनिकेशन दे रही है. आप मेरे पास आओ, आप मेरे पास नहीं आओ, या मेरे से ढंग से तरीके से बात करना. आई एम वेरी डिसिप्लिन्ड पर्सन. सो दिस इज हाउ फर्स्ट बॉडी लैंग्वेज. देन कम्स द फेस इंडेक्सेस. आप बड़े इमोजीज भेजते हो, जैसे आप व्हाट्सएप करते हो, एक स्माइलिंग इमोजी जा रहा है, एक गुस्से वाला इमोजी जा रहा है, एंड पीपल कैन अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट टाइप ऑफ एक्सप्रेशंस यू वांटेड टू गिव. तो सैडनेस, हैप्पीनेस, एंगर, वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड फ्रॉम दीज इमोजीज. व्हाट आर द दिस व्हाट व्हाट इज दिस जस्ट हियर. सो अब इफ समवन मूव्स हिज हर हेड अप. हेड से क्या होता है? मैंने बोला नॉडिंग, यस. आपने पूछा कुछ खाना है, आपने बोला यस आई वॉन्ट इट. यू अंडरस्टैंड? यस आई नो, आई अंडरस्टैंड. आर यू एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड? नो. सो हमारी गर्दन, हम लोग जब सिर हिलाते हैं, जो जिस भी डायरेक्शन में घूमता है सिर, जिस भी तरह से है, तो हमने उसकी एक लैंग्वेज डिपिक्ट की है कि अगर वो नोडिंग हो रही है दैट मीन्स हाँ, ऐसे गर्दन हिल रहा है तो इसका मतलब ना. तो दीज आर द डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ हेड कम्युनिकेशन, एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ हेड विच आर कम्युनिकेटिंग. आई गेज, हमारा आंखें फैल जाए, तो दैट मीन्स एस्टॉनिश्ड, वी आर एस्टॉनिश्ड, और हम बड़े प्यार से देख रहे हैं, या हमारे आंखें नम बंद कर रही, तो ये सब आईज से हम वी कैन गिव अवर एक्सप्रेशंस. नाउ जेस्टर्स, पोस्टर्स, जो मैंने अभी आपको बताया, बॉडी लैंग्वेज, जेस्टर्स, दे ऑल गिव अस द हाउ वी कैन कम्युनिकेट नॉन वर्बली. शेप ऑफ बॉडी, अरे ये तो बड़ा मोटा है, बहुत खाता होगा इसीलिए मोटा है, या बैठा होता होगा, लेजी है. सो उसकी बॉडी जो है वो हमें बता रही है कि भाई ये क्या करता होगा, तो वो कम्युनिकेट करे उसकी बॉडी. हम एक अपना एक्सप्रेशन हमने कोट किया हुआ है, पतला दुबला, इसको खाने को नहीं मिलता होगा, या ये चिढ़ता होगा बहुत ज्यादा, जलता होगा, तो हम लोग उस तरह से उसकी बॉडी से वी टेक आउट एक्सप्रेशन एंड वी कम्युनिकेट अवर ब्रेन दैट ये इसकी जो बॉडी है इसकी वजह से हमको समझ में आ रहा है भैया ये कैसा बंदा होगा. अब पर्सनल अपीयरेंस, अब किसी ने बहुत अच्छे कपड़े पहने तो कहते हैं अरे बड़ा पैसे वाला है, और अगर उसने थोड़ा सा गरीब का तो हम, या फिर उसने बहुत बड़ी पगड़ी बांधी हुई जैसे अगर आप देखें तो हम कहते हैं राजस्थानी है, अच्छा इसने ये पहना हुआ, ये मुस्लिम है. तो जस्ट जो हमारे रिलीजियंस है, कल्चरल है, वो भी हमें कम्युनिकेट करते हैं कि किस तरह की हमारी अपीयरेंस से हमें पता चलता है कि वॉट टाइप ऑफ पर्सन वी आर. एंड देन हैप्टिक्स, जो हमारे टच थ्योरी जो होती है हमारी, वो हमेशा हमें कम्युनिकेट करती है, जैसे कि अभी हमने वो वीडियो में भी देखा एनिमल्स वाले में. तो टच ऑलवेज टेल यू कि इसका टच जो है बहुत प्यार वाला है, इसका वार्म है, ये मेरी मदर मेरे को बहुत प्यार कर रही है. स्पेस लैंग्वेज, अगर मैं अपने किसी डायरेक्टर से या टीचर्स के साथ बात करती हूँ तो वी हैव अ स्पेस इन बिटवीन. अगर मेरा मैनेजर है, टीम लीड है, तो और दोस्त होगा तो उसके हमने कंधे में कंधा डाला हुआ है और बाजू पे बाजू डाला हुआ है, अरे यार तू आ जा, तो दिस इज द स्पेस लैंग्वेज. इसी से पता चलता है ये दोस्त है, ये बॉस एंड एम्प्लॉय है कोई, तो इस वजह से स्पेस लैंग्वेज होती है वो हमारे को डिपिक्ट करती है कि किस तरह का नॉन वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन से हमें पता चल जाता है कि या इन दोनों के बीच में कैसा बॉन्डिंग है. Now we come to the science which we are talking about, science theory. Then Articraft environment factors. कहते हैं यार आज ना बहुत dull मौसम है, लाइट बहुत कम है तो बड़ा डल डल हो रहा है, बहुत मन आज वैसा हो रहा है क्योंकि मौसम भी ऐसा है बाहर ऐसा, या फिर रेनी सीजन है बहुत अच्छा सा, ओ मजा आ रहा है यार मौसम बहुत अच्छा चलो घूमने चलते हैं. सो दीज आर द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ एनवायरमेंट एंड ये हम समझ सकते हैं. अब आ गया हमारा क्रोनिक टाइम लैंग्वेज. अगर कोई बच्चा मतलब टाइम से कहीं जाके हम पहुंच रहे हैं तो हम कहते हैं शी इज वेरी पंचुअल, शी इज ओ शी कम्स इन टाइम, शी इज वेरी, तो हमें उसका नेचर उसका स्वभाव पता चल रहा है उसके टाइम टाइम से कि भाई वो पंचुअल है ये है, तो ये होता है टाइम लैंग्वेज. देन अगेन साइलेंस, हम कहते हैं एक चुप सौ सुख, अगर आपको गुस्सा आ रहा है आप चुप हो जाइए बात निकल चुकी. So, allowing silence in a conversation puts pressure on the other person. Silence can indicate hostility. Silence can indicate disagreement. Silence can indicate profoundness such as horror. Silence can indicate respect. Silence can indicate contemplation. Silence can be intentional rudeness. And silence can be creation of a listening space. So, मतलब आप ये समझ लीजिए कि silence से हम कितनी सारी चीजें communicate कर सकते हैं. मैं अपना गुस्सा भी कर सकती हूँ और मैं दुख भी कर सकती हूँ, प्यार भी कर सकती हूँ, मैं ये दिखा सकती हूँ कि मैं कंसंट्रेट होकर सुन रही हूँ. सो साइलेंस कैन एक्ट एज अ सो मेनी, इट कैन बी एक्ट एज अ वेरी गुड मीडिया ऑफ एवरीथिंग. देन आता है आपका वोकैलिक्स. अगर हम जोर से बोलते हैं गुस्से तो हम कहते हैं गुस्से से बोल रहा है, आज पापा को बहुत गुस्सा आ रहा था, ही वॉज लाइक शाउटिंग लाइक एनीथिंग, और अरे मम्मी ने तो बड़े प्यार से समझाया. सो वट एवर द रेजोनेंस इन द वॉइस, so it will tell you what type of communication is going in between two people. Now the topic effective communication. तो ये सब चीजें हमारे सब चीजें क्यों मैंने पढ़ाया आपको communication, कि कल को जब आपसे मुझसे ये कहा गया कि भाई आप इसके बारे में बताना, तो I thought कि चलिए पहले थोड़ा सा बता के अच्छा she's running or just wait बस प्रतिमा thank you so much for telling me. Give me at least 2 minutes, 3 minutes. Okay, 2-3 minutes. Okay, fine. This is, I think, it's the third last slide. So gather your thoughts. So first of all, जब भी आप कभी किसी से बात करें, whenever you wanted to talk, want to communicate, understand what is the agenda of your communication. उसकी accordingly आपकी ये सब चीजें तैयार होनी चाहिए. Gather your thoughts, choose your words, voice modulation, body language, listen, concentrate, eye contact, postures, simple or familiar language and questioning skills. Fine. Then we comes to wait. Benefits of effective communication: quicker problem solving, better decision making, steady workflow, strong business relations and better professional. We have talked each point in the complete all the slides when we are running together. And improving verbal communication tips: eliminate noise, get feedback, verbal and body signals, speak slowly and rehearse your sentences, don't talk down to the other person and listen carefully and patiently. Agar hum apni improve karna chahte hain verbal communication skills, to ye tips hain ki aapko kya karna hai. Ab main ek bilkul band kamre mein baithi hu jahan pe koi silence hai because I wanted to teach you. So eliminate noise, get feedback, verbal and body signals, jo bhi aapka feedback hai I will be taking in the last. Speak slowly and rehearse your sentence, ko bhi aapka proper tarike se bolna. Don't talk down to the, ab kya hota hai ki kai bar hum bolte chale jate hain nobody, aur hum kisi ko allow bhi karte, to wo cheez nahi honi chahiye. Aur apni body language ko aapko improve karna padega, ki agar hum kabhi baat kar rahe hain, baat hum kuch kar rahe hain, hamare actions kuch ho rahe hain, to you have to be very very tight about your body language. Keep appropriate distance, touch only when appropriate, take care of your parents, be aware people may give false clues, maintain eye contact and smile genuinely. And this is the success for you in the new global and diverse workplace. It requires excellent communication skills. So if it is not there, then definitely nobody will like to you that he or she is not able to speak out, he or not able to give a better communicate, he is not able to write, he is not able to speak, he is not able to express. So you have to work on your communication, because you are moving toward industry, your jobs or your teaching or your further higher learning. So you have to be very good in your communication. So success for you in the new global and diverse workplace requires, because these days everything is going digital, so you have to be work according to the diverse situation and requires excellent communication skills. So this is the end of my presentation. I will be opening the dash for the question. If anybody likes to have the communication, anything wanted to ask me, I am there to give you the answers.
Thank you, ma'am, for your enlightening words. This session was indeed a great learning experience for all of us. Now, I would like to invite Dr. Divya Chaudhary, Director, Jagran Institute of Management, to take questions and thank Dr. Kataria.
Right. Thank you, Dr. Naveen. A very good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen and dear students. In fact, it is my proud privilege to welcome you all on such an interesting topic of learning. Dr. Babita, first of all, thank you so much for enlightening us on a very pertinent area, that is effective communication skills, especially at this time of house arrest. I agree with you that continuous comprehension evaluation is important to innovate, learn, excel, and comprehend. And just in order to share that it was really overwhelming for all of us over here in ZIM to see that more than 700 people showed interest and registered for our webinar today. But due to the maximum limit of participants allowed by Zoom, we cannot allow everyone. And I'm pretty sure and believe that we all are together watching it on Facebook Live and commenting. In fact, there were more than 300 questions, and compressing and comprehending was a real challenge for all of us. In fact, as you said, Dr. Babita, we can take a few questions. So first of all, we have with us Hitika Goswami. Hitika, can you unmute yourself and please introduce and ask the question?
First of all, Dr. Divya, thank you so much for your warm welcome and also for listening me from, I think, 45-50 minutes. Thank you so much for listening me on all the faculty members.
It is a pleasure. And the students. Always welcome. It is a pleasure, ma'am. Thank you so much.
So now please ask the questions.
Thank you, Divya, ma'am. Good afternoon, ma'am, and good afternoon to all who have joined this webinar. First of all, I want to thank Jagran Institute of Management for giving me this opportunity. Ma'am, my name is Hritika Goswami and I'm a student of BCom Honours from Banaras Hindu University. And I want to know that what are some of the guiding tips to outperform in group discussion? Ma'am, my question is clear to you.
Yeah. Outperformance for group discussion. This is the question.
Yes, ma'am.
So what do you mean by group discussion? What do you mean by
ma'am, good communication means we can attract
group discussion. I'm talking about group discussion. What do you mean by group discussion?
What, ma'am?
What do you mean by group discussion?
Ma'am, group discussion means in which many people joined and some topics arises and we have to share our views on this topic.
Yeah. So that means it is a discussion. It is not a fighting place. So one is,
yes, ma'am,
that it is meaning the that you have to know that you have to respect each and every individual in your group. So you have to try to listen. You have not to impose the things. So first of all, this is the main tip which has been required. Normally people, what they think that in the group discussion, we have to just shout, we have to impose, they make a fish market. No, you are not supposed to do that. You have to just listen to each other and you can discuss as you discuss in your home, as you discuss it among your friends. So this is the main tip which I feel that it should be there. Other than that, your body language, your data compilation, whatever the topic is, if you are not very clear, you should listen to other people. Sometimes it happens the topic which has been given, which is not, we are not able to understand. We cannot gather our thought process, what is the things which should, we should speak. So that time, you just listen to other people and make a frame inside your brain, and then you can speak out.
Well answered.
Okay.
I hope I'm clear.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much.
That is great. Thank you so much, ma'am. I can see there's another question from Ujjwal Bhardwaj. Ujjwal, are you here?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, please go ahead.
Good afternoon, ma'am. My name is Ujjwal Bhardwaj. I'm 19 years old. I'm currently doing my Bachelor's of Commerce from IP University. And my question is, what are the activities that we can do on our daily basis for improving our communication skills?
Okay, very nice question, Ujjwal, and I would love to speak about it because I'm related to industry and I have got a very high feedback from the people from the industry that the communication skill is lacking in between the student, whether it is from IP University, whether it is from Kanpur University, wherever they are, because we are not working on our communication. So first, and the first step is when you are speaking, you should be very, 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 very clear. You have your mobile with you. In that, you have an audio recorder. So take some few lines and speak. You will come to know that what is the difference. You make a comparative. When a news reader is speaking in the news, how she or he is speaking and how you are speaking. So you have an audio recorder. You can teach yourself, one. Second, I have in my presentation told you about the vocabulary. You have to learn your vocabulary. Where that particular word can be used, which can make your effective communication, effective sentences. Then when we are concatenating your sentence, one sentence to another sentence, where we are lacking, we are converting Hindi into English in our mind and we are trying to speak. So this is making a hazard in our communication because we are lack of vocabulary, we are lack of thought process. So that is why we are not able to say effective communications. We are not effectively communicate our expression. So hum kehte hain hame Hindi mein bolne diya jaye to hum bahut acha bolenge kyunki Hindi hamari matrabhasha hai. Kyun nahi hum English mein bol pa rahe? Kyunki English mein hamare paas words ki kami hai, hamare paas sentence making ki kami hai. तो आपको सबसे पहले अपनी वोकैबुलरी पे अपना कंपैरिजन कि हमारा जो बोलने का तरीका है क्या वो क्लियर है, क्या ऐसा है वो स्लो, बहुत स्लो नहीं, ऐसी स्पीड है उसकी कि जो कोई भी सुन सके, कानों को सूदिंग हो, बहुत चिल्ला नहीं रहे, बहुत धीरे नहीं बोल रहे. तो आपका जो एक बैलेंस वॉइस है इट शुड बी देयर, बैलेंस स्पीड शुड बी देयर, बैलेंस एंड गुड वर्ड्स इन योर कम्युनिकेशन एंड इट शुड बी वेरी सिंपल. सी आई राइट माई मेल्स, आप मेरी मेल्स पढ़िए, मैं दो लाइनें लिखती हूँ, बिल्कुल छोटी सी लैंग्वेज लिखती हूँ. आई एम फाइन, आई कैन गो देयर एंड आई विल ब्रिंग दिस दिस. अब इसी को आप किसी भी तरीके से मोड़ दो, इसको पूरा पैराग्राफ बना दो इसी बात को समझाने के लिए, या अपनी बात को दो लाइनों में बोल दो. तो आपको वो सेंटेंस कि आप किसी चीज को फ्रेम 10 लाइनों में कर सकते हो या दो लाइनों में कर सकते हो, और दो लाइनें वो ऐसी इफेक्टिव हो कि मैं पढ़ूं या मैं बोलूं तो वो इमिजिएटली लोगों को मेरी भाव समझ आ जाए. So this is my answer, Ujjwal. I hope I am clear about my answer.
Well explained, ma'am. I think English being the business language, we will have to focus on English and as a good learner, keep learning. Due to the paucity of time, I think I can take one more question. And this is from our student, Anand from MCA. Anand, can you ask your question, please?
Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon, ma'am. My name is Anand. I am a student of MCA, Jagran Institute of Management. And ma'am, my question is, what are the greatest challenge in communication in COVID-19 pandemic from the viewpoint of placements?
Okay. Thank you, Anand. It's a very, very nice question and very near to my heart. See, I was taking care of 750 colleges of Equity. As you all know, it is an affiliating university and it is Asia's one of the biggest university having 750 colleges under it. So when we have started this UIIC, I can just give you an example and you can understand. So when we have started this UIIC, University Industry Interface Cell of AKTU, so we have a very big challenge how to connect with all these colleges. Right. So there we have an ERP system. And you people are having it because जहाँ से आप अपना admit card download करते हैं, जहाँ से आप अपना data को update करते हैं. So we were having that phase. We were just facing that problem. So we connected with us with ERP. So we are connected with each and every students. So first communication is that we are connected with our students. Number one, we accepted that challenge and we took out the solution. One. Second, we have notices. Third, we have director's email IDs. Fourth, we have training and placement officers' email IDs. Then we started asking the students to make their profile on UIIC. So we have a resume writing, a format which has been required by us to capture the data. So that is another solution for this communication. And finally, we have been connected with the students through online emails or SMS or something like everything like that. Then we developed a UIC web page, which is again a communication. Again, वहाँ पे हम सारी की सारी postings करते थे, अपनी सारा कुछ करते थे. So these are the one thing and one aspect which is from the university side. Another aspect is corporate. So अब corporate जो रहा था, हम लोग उसके साथ physical campus कर रहे थे, जा रहे थे, company colleges में जाते थे, campus करके जाते थे, वहाँ पे एक lab में जाके online test हो गया, बच्चे shortlist हो गया, उसके interview चल रहे हैं, panels आए हैं, सब कुछ. Finally, this digital came, this pandemic came in the picture. And because of this pandemic, everything was like, what to do now? How the campus hiring will be done? The student will not get the job immediately because a part of it, we were using it digitally because some companies' online tests we were doing previously also. Immediately, all the companies transformed themselves and converted themselves on the online digital media. And immediately we did also. And we are again connected. And we are doing our campus hiring process of Amazon, Wipro, of any TCS, any company, we are doing online. Because earlier to that, it was Skype, where some interviews are being done on Skype. Now, Google Meet is there, Cisco is there, WebEx is there, any media, Zoom is there. So we have been connected. So this is how we have overcome this situation and we are digitally connected with our students. And see the example today, I am meeting 700 students which are not able to connect through Zoom, but they are again connected through live with YouTube. And we are connected. And when this video is, because it isn't recorded, so it will be kept there forever. So this my media is used, this communication is been used. And you know, my this speech or my today's session, director's ma'am session, your question answer, everything will be live there. Anybody can go and reach. So see the reach. And this is how we have accepted and taken this challenge positively. And we have converted ourselves. I hope I am clear, Anna.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, Dr.
Bhattacharya. Thank you, ma'am.
For such a nice, elaborative explanation. I hope Anand is also satisfied with the answer. Thank you once again on behalf of Jagan Institute of Management. And I would like to express my gratitude with this e-certificate and would like to keep in connect with you in near future also. Thank you so much.
On behalf of me, I pay my sincere thanks and regards to the management of Jagran Institute, to the faculty members, the director, Dr. Divya, Dr. Naveen, who has introduced me, and definitely and never to forget Ms. Pratima, who has invited me over here on this platform, and especially to my other faculty members and HODs who have been there in the on this platform. I'm very happy to meet you all, and especially to my very, very loving students who is very, very near to my heart, Anand and Shivani and Arshika, everybody I will remember. Thank you so much for inviting me. Thank you so much.
You are welcome.
Thank you. So I, with your permission, can I leave for the day or I have to
be sure. No, ma'am, we will not ask you to stay long. If you wish to, you're most welcome. But if you have engagements, please continue.
So after the second speaker, I will. Thank you so much. Thank you. I'm there in the session. Okay, thank you.
Go. Thank you, Dr. Kataria. And thank you, Dr. Divya. Now it's time for our next speaker of the day. I am honored to introduce Mr. Avnish Srivastav. Mr. Srivastav is working as an independent consultant for What Next. He has done his master's from Lucknow University in Human Resource Management and Industrial Relations. Previously, he has served Bajaj Alliance Life Insurance and Edelweiss Tokyo Life Insurance as Associate Vice President. Srivastav specializes in organizing workshops, sales and soft skill trainings, problem solving and critical thinking coaching, mentorship programs, and team building. He has been awarded with, he has received a number of awards for his performance and professional achievements. The list of achievements is long and may take 5 more minutes to share. So without making any further delays, I would now request Mr. Srivastav to share his expertise. Mr. Srivastav.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. It's almost afternoon now. Thank you for this opportunity to be at this platform. And I would just quickly read a confirmation whether my presentation is being visible or not. Is it visible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So without taking much time, I think everybody has been waiting for long for the slots, including me, because of two reasons. One is about the subject that I have chosen to interact with all of you. And second being the fact that it's an opportunity after a long time when you interact with people and of a territory which you all always belong to. I also belong to a place called UP Lucknow. I started my studies, so it's a little nostalgic to be a part of the team and people around who are who belong to the same place where you have started your journey from. So to give the context right, I hope this first slide that talks about something called career proofing. In our careers and the way we have seen our education and the way we have been able to build our education system and expect ourselves accordingly to deliver results in terms of our careers, I think we have to revise and revisit the world called career proofing. The objective of using this word is very simple. Hum ghar ki waterproofing karate hain, and there's a logic of creating some safety net to be able to make sure our premises and the is utilized properly in that context. And hence, while we discuss the world called career proofing, it means there may be no guarantee in terms of deciding what can come back to you as a resultant which you want to achieve, but it can always give you a resultant option in terms of what exactly can you achieve when you decide an education system to help you, or when you decide a course to help you. For example, all those students who are a part of this webinar right now must have taken a reason for themselves why they wanted to do this course of an MBA. See, geographies do not matter. The reason I'm trying to highlight this question that might be there in the minds of many who are listening right now is that while we opted to take options of the institutions that we will take our education from, for example, humne aapne sabne career UP se start kiya, and as the previous speaker, Dr. Ma'am was trying to refer to us by saying whether the corporate believes us that we have good communication skills or not, is English a medium to decide a career? Mera education system decide karega, ki mera institution decide karega, ki mera past score in my subjects decide karega ki how good am I be and I can be. So the game is all about how do I redefine what I can achieve by the options that I had in my past and the way opportunities will keep on coming to you every time you go into the market. When I say market, I mean to say the industry, the options of utilizing it. Hello? Is it fine? Yeah, I hope so. So the game is about understanding what can we do if we have to career-proof our own education, or what can we do to make sure that there can be possible career-proofing of all what we want to achieve. And if we happen to make a career out of that, how do I sustain that career for long so that it helps us grow to the desired level of competence that we want to achieve, or satisfaction in terms of the contribution that we want to make to the society. To be able to understand that, we need to understand a concept called VUCA. So when we say VUCA, it clearly talks about a potential term in terms of four-letter word called VUCA, that is volatility, uncertainty, complexity and ambiguity. I think there's some, I'm not able to move the slides right now. I'm going to present a view. Is it visible still?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, thank you. So while we talk about this, we should understand what is VUCA all about or what is career all about. So first point is, remember there's no manual, there's no procedure, there's no description, there's no prescription, there's no automated machine system which will define what career is. Obviously, there can be options and thought process of people that practice to build, but there's no defined manual which will give you rules how to define your career and make it successful. Even if you have those rules clear to yourself, no two careers can be alike. For example, a person that you see, you want to replicate and you want to be him like or be her like. It doesn't mean that two people who maybe have different career profiles may be similar, or two common people may have similar careers. So no two careers are alike. Timing of deciding how do you define your career, when do you decide your career, is critically important. For example, we all got the option of working in terms of taking decision with our parents during our times when they had the level of understanding how careers will be defined during time. For example, if you ask 20 years back and go back and try to engage with those parents and ask what they would have seen a future for you, many of us would have got shortlisted to our two dimension options called either to be a doctor or engineer, for example. And hence, for the last 5-6 years, or rather since last a decade, you will see the options of multiple options within the system and streams coming up, which gives you a view where you can actually redefine how things can make. So timing becomes hugely important and critical of defining a career. Next is, when we say career, how do we actually think about a career? A career cannot be made unless it gives you satisfaction. Whether you say in terms of being able to understand and the value of what you want to do or what you want to give back to the society. The concept of career is, if you are able to make a contribution which can give back to you in terms of personal satisfaction, and hence career can be redefined. So career is all about going beyond the boundaries of the job descriptions that you have, whether in the industry or the job description, whether you are getting your education. We'll think and we'll talk in detail today, and whatever time that we have in the next slides, you will try to focus on this point. And lastly, and more important, is remember the world is not that we all imagine. So if you have to go towards career proofing, if you want to redesign the way you look forward to your career, it is important for you to understand that you will be facing a lot of frustrations. Now, if you want to make your career proof, remember there will be parts in life, there will be challenges in life in your education system where you need to build a defense mechanism. As aaj hum log ke liye bahut important that we have to build immunity system to be able to fight COVID. Similarly, career has a lot of frustrations. So career proofing also means, can we do something about getting prepared for those frustrations which may come in near future? So this checklist of 5 points is the summary around which I have tried to build this presentation. The presentation is all about my personal experiences of my own journey for last 22 years, starting from a student who stood up in a queue of looking for an MBA firm for marketing, landed up choosing a firm for Masters in Human Resource. A guy who has never scored great marks in maths, but have spent around 18 years in financial services. A guy who has never been able to understand how career could pre-decide how good and bad a person can be, or a good or a bad person decides how a good career can be. So there are a lot of questions that comes in mind, and hence have taken personal project of this since last 1 year, which I personally call it as What Next, which solves a lot of questions. So the idea is all about whether we have these redefined questions coming in our mind. So what I have tried to do in the next 30, 45 minutes, whatever time it is allowed to me, is to bring down those thoughts in form of pictures. Now, these pictures will also give you a lot of questions. These questions will park those certain questions to be answered at the end of the presentations. but at the same time, our focus should remain on what we are trying to exchange. Obviously, while it may be more of a one-way traffic that we might not be able to exchange a lot of thoughts in terms of exchanging, how do we look at it? But still, I have a personal belief that we can build a lot of opportunity to learn out of this. And with this, I wanted to present you a world called VUCA. I think most of you, and especially those who are being in management, might be in IT, in MCA, must have heard and heard this word in your books, in news, over the internet, where it has kept on coming to your mind by saying, what is VUCA? VUCA is a new concept which was defined 5 years or almost 8 years before, which talks about the current situation, the industry and the market works. And hence, VUCA needs to be understood. The career would be a VUCA career now. So remember, you can't be different from what the world is behaving like. You can't be different when you are within the system. There was a movie which talks about that if you want to change the system, you have to be part of the system. So if you want to change your career, you have to be part of what the industry and this timing and the market is facing through. So the market is going through a VUCA situation, which talks about first as being volatile. It's when volatile simply means there'll be rapid changes. When there'll be rapid changes, you are going to face a lot of uncertainty. When uncertainty means you'll have a lot of doubts. So when you'll have doubts, things would be complex to you. So complexity or complex means the doubts will lead to creation of complexity. And hence, when there'll be a lot of complexity or doubts, you may have ways and means to find different answers. And same thing might lead to your different interpretations. For example, there are multiple thoughts people are facing today in terms of understanding what is COVID. You see a lot of exchanges happening on social media. You must be receiving a lot of WhatsApp messages. Yeah. People, And hence, this VUCA as a word tells us the journey that in the rapid changing world, there'll be a lot of uncertainty that will come, which will create doubts and would also lead to complexities, which will be difficult for us to understand. And hence, it will convert into ambiguity, which will create a platform of multiple ways of interpreting the same situation. So the smart way to understand or the things that comes into the mind is what is that we can do? And hence, what next? It simply talks about, and if you take this principle back to your own career, when you filled up the form to become a student of management or MCA or IT or marketing, whatever specialization, are these four phases being a part of your journey and how you can actually elaborate to make it career proof? So if you simply try to align those things, if you have rapid changes being experiencing in the market, the only thing which can help you to forget focus is define a vision for yourself. So let me give an example or a small concept that you will be able to retain this more. So while you are experiencing a lot of volatility in the system and your education system, the kind of thoughts and challenges that you face as a student or might be a professional at times, you need to be very sure the only track is to create a long-term vision. So when we say long-term vision, try to assume as if you are a train which is moving on a railway track. Remember, the railway track is the vision. The railway track will keep you, it should be decided very clearly that whether you change the engine, whether you change the bogies, whether you change, you have a decision of getting down at any station, coming back and boarding the train again. This will continue, the process will continue. But the railway track will remain the same. For example, you buy a ticket from Lucknow to Delhi, you have multiple stations that will come in between. You board a train. In the train, you may have second class, first class, you may have unreserved class. That depends on the quality of options that you have. The engine would certainly move in one direction. The moment it leaves the track, you don't get results. So what is volatile? Volatility? Volatility is nothing when you lose the track of what you wanted to achieve. And hence you get spikes in the curve, which is a natural process. It happens everywhere. It happens in personal life. It happens in professional life. It happens in equity market. It happens in FDs. Of guaranteed or instruments, you talk of anything in life. So volatility is a part of natural process which will happen and will continue. So what happened next? How do you manage uncertainty? So uncertainty is equal to when you have a lot of doubts. The only way you can overcome the doubt that you have for anything and you start feeling uncertain about anything is by clear and understanding in details. Now, understanding does not mean the way you understand. Being aware and being knowledgeable are two different things. Knowledge should give you a platform to become aware, or awareness will give you your knowledge is a big question to ask. My recommendation strongly is that we should always try to create awareness first, which will give you a lot of knowledge. At times, the preconceived knowledge blocks you from being aware. And I'm not trying to contradict any process of education or the system that we follow, but my strong recommendation to education system would be that if we create a lot of awareness and let people choose what can be knowledge for them, because knowledge should be able to give them intent and skills and ability to implement it somewhere. So you guys who are listening to me right now in this webinar should decide today, are you going to your institution, to your professors, to your college, and have you decided a career of education opted because you wanted to gain knowledge or whether you wanted to become aware? My personal suggestion would be become aware. If you become aware of things that you are learning, the education you are taking, you'll be able to gain a lot of knowledge. And hence this knowledge you can always pick down, being aware of what is good and what is not, what is applicable, what is not, what you would like to do, what you would not like to do, what is easy for you, what gives you a kick, which is a part of your passion, or what something is just because it is required. And hence your time and energy gets flowed in a similar manner. Next is being complex. So complexity was equal to when there's something called difficult to understand. Remember, while you were trying to clear the awareness will lead to complexity, because the more you become aware, there will be a situation that things will become complex because you get to know too many things. And that's the point of time where most of us give up. Because when we get into a journey of being aware, you will face too many facts and they may have different ways which will come to you. And hence, this will become a complex process, and to convert that complexity into clarity is a big journey. And hence, last and not the least, when there's a lot of clarity, you will have ambiguity. Now, when you have clear about what you want to do, for example, I'm very clear that I'm talking to you, but there's a lot of ambiguity. Are you listening or not? Is this going to work or not? Is it going to be useful for the people who are listening to me or not? Similarly, when there's a clarity, there will be a chance that you will be able to interpret those clarities in multiple ways. So when you interpret a thing into multiple ways, or a subject or a work that you do in multiple ways, that's called ambiguity. The ambiguity is nothing when a thing or a subject can be interpreted in multiple ways. The only way to be able to reduce that, to be agile. So you move the way that possibilities can be. For example, if somebody asked today, if somebody has taken mathematics, I think 20 years before, people would say somebody has taken physics, chemistry, and maths in class 12, that means he's going to opt for engineering. Now you will see people and IITians dropping out from IITians, and they're also doing thinking and they're doing stand-up comedy. So ambiguity, being aware, would also give you a lot of interpretation the way we think, and hence would give you agility in terms of a guy who started with PCM must have prepared for his IITs. He went through his post-graduation might be in the institution, and he discovers after a long time that he is made for to be a stand-up comedian. Might be, and he successfully does that. I don't know whether you guys follow. There are multiple challenges. I can't name this officially here. Who are the alumni of IITs who are doing a full time job, doing online media, doing something which is beyond what is happening. And hence, you find the process of creation of intelligence, which started from student opting to become IITians, going to become civil servants, and hence landing up doing their own business, or an IITian who is chemical engineer becoming a CEO of a company and managing sales. So in this complex world, you can't have a decision unless you go through this process. So VUCA is a natural opportunity for all of us to go through. And for me, if you want to actually go to the concept of career proofing, you need to be very specifically clear about these four words called VUCA. How to manage volatility, how to overcome uncertainty, how to understand complexity and clarity, and similarly, being very, very agile to be able to manage multiple opportunities. So let's start with the first option of how can we actually make it easier for us to convert a volatile environment by managing a concept called vision. So as I told you, example, vision is almost like a railway track on which you decide to board through a train, which you need an engine, could have multiple bogies, you buy a ticket depending upon your capacity, but you reach the same destination. For example, a guy who is reaching, who's bought a ticket of second AC versus third AC, or might be a non-AC or a non-reserved class, can also reach Delhi by boarding the same train. So destinations can be same. It can be achieved by having a clear vision, subject to all of them board the right train and that train moves on the right track. So track, maintaining that vision is critical. Now, how do we see that? Let's take two examples to understand that. The first part is, if vision has to be defined as something called creating a super career for yourself, how would you redefine that? Now, there are three words involved in it. Creating super career. Now, creating is how do you create that super career? So you need to define, first of all, what is career for you? How will you be able to make it super? And what do you create for within yourself and your environment around to make it a super career? So it's about a three-step process. Now, how does it go? If you have to principally understand this concept in short period of time, it's a big subject to discuss. It can't actually be covered in 45 minutes. But I'm trying to highlight two important words that come in picture, which has been said by Peter Drucker. He says very clearly, efficiency is doing right things and effectiveness is doing the things right, the right things. Now, there's a small change of words which makes a hell of a lot of difference in what is efficiency and what is effectiveness. I think we should spend some time to understand this. So if we have to differentiate and understand what is efficiency and what is effectiveness, the one way to look at it is efficiency is doing things right. That means being competitive. Now, and effectiveness is doing right things, where you have need competence. You would be able to do right thing consistently only when you have evolved and achieved certain level of competence in yourself. Now, competence is the process that you have to develop with time, and hence education should play a big role. Hence, you should create an opportunity within the framework that you work with in the opportunity, given opportunity environment, because we can't say I'm not competent, but I'm educated. Now, if you're educated and you're not competent, that means you know the right things, but you don't know how to do it. Knowing the right thing is knowledge. How to do right things is what the industry requires. And I think Dr. Babita, in the previous interaction with you, what she was insisting about how she is experiencing when she interacts with the industry. It's a great honor to connect with her on this platform, and I will certainly connect back to her later as well. So remember, the competent part would give you one base strong thing of doing one thing very good on the right way. But if you're not competitive in an industry environment, because you have to produce results and you have to give consistent profit, and hence doing right things means those numbers which can be in quantity and quality and can be defined in terms of parameters of time. So that's why targets, that's why quality, that's why in terms of being competitive, is defined. So if you are only competent and non-competitive, it's not going to survive. If you're only competitive, you can't be competitive for long if you're not competent. So career proofing now converts and merges into two simple words. It's revolving around efficiency and being efficient. Hence, what do I do to develop my competencies so that I can be competitive in the market? So to summarize quickly, I think we focused on two basic points here to understand the difference between effectiveness and efficiency, and to understand that efficiency is equal to or as good as being competitive, and effectiveness is as good as being competent. Competency is your job. And to be able to acquire through skills and continuous learning process. It's a never-ending process, actually. And competitiveness is output of competency at times. So how do we actually see that? Let's have a quick framework to make you understand that. So on an axis, we draw the things of doing the right way, that is called effectiveness, versus doing the right things. Right way and right things as an efficiency is a matrix. So the first grid talks about anybody who has got low efficiency and low effectiveness, what it means is you're doing wrong things the wrong way. So if you do wrong things the wrong way, I think you don't have a chance. There's no chance of career proofing. Forget about career proofing. I think there's absolutely no chance that you'll stand the wind that you're going to face when you go to the industry or you go for your careers outside the domain. And career, mind you, is not only about seeking a job opportunity to work 24/7 or 8 hours in a sitting on a career. Is much beyond that. Even if you want to start something of your own and being a solopreneur or want to fund yourself, want to grow, I think it requires to understand that you have to do right things. So doing wrong things wrong way leads you nowhere. So second option, if you do right things the wrong way, it may happen for some time, but it will not be sustainable. So efficiency being high and effectiveness being low does not give you sustenance. It will give you a start. It will give you a glimpse. It may give you a primary set of success at times. Next comes is doing the wrong things the right way. Now that, so you that may be very confusing. For example, there was a discussion that happened yesterday night with our information and technology minister and law minister, Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad. He was giving an interview. Somebody asked him, the question was asked by an anchor of a news channel, that whether social media should be allowed the way it functions. So there was some dispute which happened, which says that private sector should be allowed to make profit because we should not get into managing those because they are supposed to deliver opportunities and career. And the other view was, so the right way, so who is going to do the right? There was something, certainly a right way of doing the business. But if it delivers wrong things, for example, insecurity or risk to the country, I think it does not solve the purpose. It would give you some results, but it would not again be sustainable. It can be challenging. It can be problematic at times. So being highly effective but poor in efficiency is not that going to give you a career proofing. So what gives you career proofing? It's simply doing the right things the right way. I hope if we have traveled through the few slides in the past, we have been able to come to a conclusion that your career proofing revolves around two words, efficiency and being effective. Now, to be able to understand that, you have to be in the right combination, do the right things the right way. So when you do right things the right way, it gives you results, it gives you consistent results, it gives you sustainable results. Now, if you try to relate this question back to yourself as a student of management or whatever stream that you have chosen, that when you took this admission in any of these school and college that you are right now, are you doing the right things the right way? For example, we have assignments. We are supposed to read books. We are supposed to do a lot of collaboration, study beyond our classes. Now, in the current situation where COVID is affected, that you are not being able to get a physical interface, how are you managing yourself? And how is your career going to go back just because small process changes happened? You need to think as a student of management yourself. Now, if this situation is not for today, for example, let me give an example. Do you people talk about work from home, changing of interaction and COVID being a challenge in delivering what is happening? In my initial days of career, when I started before my initial qualification in sales, we used to work independently in the field. My bosses used to travel twice in a month to see whether I'm working in the field or not. So there was a lot of discipline that was created in pharma. And this is in more than 60, 70 years that still your medical representatives in the field, they work independently and you have got very limited offices to monitor them. So why does it happen? Because people are independent of contributing towards their own career. The same thing applies to you and me. Whoever wants to move to the next level forward has to self-sustain their own discipline and deliver accordingly. Hence, a summary is, efficiency, effectiveness combined together will lead you to something called what, excellence. And remember, career proofing is equal to excellence. Now, excellence means where you control what you want to achieve, you control that how you want to do it, and you control what are the benefits you're going to get once you be able to practice it in the real time. So if you have to do this envisioning, some few good tips to be able to convert your VUCA world modality into more towards a vision. One is by deciding something that you're going to do for yourself, self-development, for example. Now, what can you do for self-development? You have to have a number, you have to fix a quantity of interventions that you want to do to yourself. When I mean to say interventions, it can be online learning, it can be classroom, it can be It can be discussion forums. It can be webinars like this. Now you have to decide ki this many numbers of inputs I'm going to gain. You have to target it very clear. Do not waste time in going to achieve a quantity without having right target. Target means, is it that going to help you in your career which you want to choose and you want to achieve? Is it going to help you to deliver your personal vision that you wanted to achieve? And lastly and most important, the quality. Now, if you don't define a number of interventions that you would like to achieve to take forward in a right target and a right quantity, it is not going to convert into self-development. So think on those lines. And second is, how do you convert these interventions into learning? Now you adopt to the execution plan. So your interventions convert into learning when you decide those methods, your positioning and the messaging that you do to yourself to be able to implement what you have learned. Hence, I'm going back to the same old point. You have to decide whether awareness comes first or knowledge. I would suggest if you get right awareness, you'll be able to pick out what to acquire as knowledge and what to drop as priority. Next section is very simple. So after modality, next was uncertainty. So how do I convert that uncertainty into understanding? Simple logic. Remember, you are a part of a two distinct world. That is something within you and there's something outside you. When we say outside you, that means you and your market are two distinct worlds, and hence the possibility that what you think and what market decides would disrupt the routine the way you want to do. For example, just imagine a situation since lockdown, how Ola has changed themselves in terms of being able to adapt to the COVID norms to be able to get a passenger onboarded. And you are seeing this is an industry, we call it as business continuity plans. Certainly you can't meet people, but you have to do sales, for example. How are we able to achieve that? Second, the social effect. What you read, what you see, and what you hear from the market around you gives you a lot of your own understanding the way you will take decisions. Hence, there's a social effect which can make a difference. So right use of social media, impactful use of social media, converting the existence of social media into your favor becomes a huge way which you can reduce the uncertainty part. Then next is very simple, that you have wavering expectations. Remember, the vision which should be able to align you to give very clearly what is that you want to achieve. Once you have set your vision clear, do not change your expectations. Do not expect too much from you yourself. Make sure that whatever you are expecting from yourself, you have to get back to answer those questions. How will I be able to reach there? Doubts is what creates uncertainty. The only way to overcome uncertainty is to reduce the doubts that you carry in your mind. And any doubts without experiencing it is dangerous. And hence, last and more important point is commit yourself. Commit yourself that what you plan to do and intend to do, you will continue to do it irrespective of the result that you experience in the first time. Unless you have achieved and experienced something at least 10 times, which gives you a reason to believe that what you want to do and what is right and what is wrong, do not take decisions. Remember, we are in a world which is diverse. What you believe, what you think is only a limited view of what can be right and wrong. Similarly, while you are trying to build your career and make it career-proof in this weaker world, you have to accept things which is a reality and a part of life. Therefore, how do you leverage the learning, and how by those learnings, how are you able to manage the challenges that you face is where the game lies. So understanding is all about how do I use the existing awareness and convert them into capabilities or knowledge which will help them implement to achieve my goals. Therefore, three things to remember. One, when somebody trains you, does not mean you are learning. There's no guarantee that any word in this webinar, you are learning anything. It all depends upon you. Training is not learning. Learning is a self-initiative. When you start finding value that you want to do something out of it. Second, whenever there'll be certain things that you want to achieve, and we should be focusing on what are the things that I can ease, which can make my jobs easier. So reduce the difficulties in your job. Last and most important thing is in this section is to be able to learn. Now, if you are learning something, you start contributing it, you'll get a feedback. When you get a feedback about what you contribute, how do you know whether what you learn is right or wrong? When you contribute to the society, when you contribute to your colleagues, when you contribute to your teachers might be, in the environment that you work for, you get a lot of feedback. When you get a lot of feedback, you develop yourself. So remember LCD. LCD is learning is only one part of it. Learning starts, contribution makes you strong, and you get to know what is right and wrong, and hence gives a lot of base and opportunity for you to develop yourself to become future ready. Now, next part was the C, that is the complexity. How do I convert that complexity into clarity? Very simple. The first is, whatever you do, please do buy-in. When I say buy-in, I mean to say is, do not take half-baked decisions. Do not, either if you've taken a decision, let's say you don't want to join sales, but you have taken a sales job. You have to start enjoying it. You can't make a career if you have taken it as a second priority. You must have faced, I don't know how many times you guys must have interacted with people come for campus recruitment, right? You have to know, don't try to change yourself because you want to crack an opportunity. Be yourself. I agree. Now, even if you have opted for something, how do you create a buying process within yourself would decide how clear you can be and how long. For example, even if I don't like a job, because I've got campus place right now in an organization, which is not the cup of tea that I wanted to enjoy at the beginning, you will get a lot of things that will help. Give yourself a target and a vision, how long you want to be there. Learn from the, who knows, after 5 years or 2 years or 3 years, you may start liking the job. Or rather, you may find that's your strength. And many a times when we don't do that, we lose great opportunities coming our way because of our myths and preoccupied notions that we carry in mind. Hence, clarity is all about deciding your next steps. In a game of chess, what step do you take and how do you plan your next step is more critical than the previous and the past steps. You can change the game in one step. Hence, clarity is about deciding what is that you want to do next. And how do you decide that? You start from a very simple place that's called, how do I differentiate between what is input and what is output? And it applies to all principles, every fact of life. If you want to redefine your career, become a successful CEO, you have to define your inputs. You have to get a great education. If you have to define what inputs would I be able to generate, you will be able to generate an output. People get confused between craving and running behind output and planning accordingly. You plan your focus towards inputs, you will be able to generate an output. At times, outputs can be targets, but targets is that something which should not decide how you will function. If you become strong enough to decide what input should I generate so that I can control my outputs, that's the way the career proofing can there. So it's always good to start from there. Next and most important three lines that I have always practiced personally has been, you will get many situations in your life, whether in corporate, as a student, as a parent, which at any part of life cycle, you will understand that reaction is the biggest problem that we have. We tend to react too soon to what we understand, hear, and see. The three-step process that is recommended is, whenever you face a situation, stop, think, and then act. The 3 or 5, 10 seconds that you give yourself stopping and thinking about a decision or an interaction or a conversation can get a hell lot of time to think and hence change the actions that you take. So most of your times, you'll find while we take decisions or even in personal relationships also, that after reacting, we start thinking about it and then we stop doing certain things. For example, if you had some friends that you didn't go well with, you react to certain situations at times, then you start thinking that you reacted wrong and hence you stop doing those behaviors later on. The right process, if in case any situation comes to you, there are possible 5 better ways to do the same thing. There's always minimum 5 ways. The only smart tip is, if something has to be reacted for, give yourself 5 seconds. Push your mind to think, can there be possible options that can be done? If any situation you are facing, there will be minimum 5 possible other ways which the situation can be dealt with. This practice can make a hell lot of difference. Last and not the least in terms of the VUCA part was ambiguity. Now, how do I manage and make my career stronger in this ambiguous world? Remember, ambiguous means that the same thing can be interpreted differently by different people. Now, but the fact of life is, because you have to co-work and coexist with those people, you need to have something called agility. Agile means to be able to understand quickly the other's opinion and hence either be able to convince him or get convinced so that the work moves ahead. The next picture very simply explains the same. There are two worlds that we work in. Most of us get caught between the two worlds. That is what you want to say and what the world is interested to hear. Somewhere between these two lies something called relevance. And the total fight in most of the careers within the industry and outside the industry has been, how do I find to be relevant in the system? So this image talks and reminds us that to be able to make your career proofing your career, it's important to find out what is the real world. Do not get swayed down by the two facts and be too artificial in terms of managing what others are interested to listen. At the same time, you can't be overwhelmed by your own facts by saying what you want to say. The convergence between these two aspects somewhere is going to help you to become relevant. And that's most critical in this current world and going forward. If this happens right, agility, as I mentioned, is your ability to move quickly. That means, remember, in the industry, if you want to make your career proof, there are two choices that you have. Most of the people have defined career or growth or good or bad career in terms of the definition of what command and control do you carry. It's a complete myth. Agility is all about empowerment. Command and control can give you a lot of rights and opportunities to implement what you're empowered for. A person who passes out from IIT Kanpur has a lot of empowerment that he has got because he has got a huge learning, subject to whether he decides to use those skills that he passed out from IIT Kanpur and uses for. For example, same pass out can become a CEO of a company, can start his own option, can give jobs to multiple people, can create something new, innovative technology which can help the world, which IIT Kanpur, for example, I'm naming IIT Kanpur because I can understand we belong, most of us as an audience might be belonging to this area right now. And hence, you can see how agility can help. Knowing the difference between empowerment and command and control differentiates the way we see career proofing. The next picture actually gives a lot of clarity in what agility means. Agility is like the apple and the Gandhi, right? So when you preserve your roots, your culture, your being there, as well as when you are able to modernize yourself as per the requirement of the current situation, that's the apple part of it. So this picture talks about and clearly reminds us that if you want to do a career proofing, we have to understand that there has to be a space of the base and the inputs and the background and the strength and the roots that you carry and still redefine yourself to the modern world, which have to be ready for future. And most important, you have to deep dive. What is your career and what is your market? So unless you understand what is the market offering as career and what is the career that you want to market yourself. So when you do a lot of deep dive means preparing yourself in advance before the opportunity comes is important. For example, after getting a job, you will not get time to study. So you have to choose how much you want to study and how much you want to actually gain confidence in terms of education. Because if you ask me, I said sometimes believe that we could have done much higher education. I personally know Dr. Divya because we have worked together in the industry earlier. And I can tell you and about each, I envy a time that I could have studied more and would have taken my career much to a much longer destination. The choices are difficult, but we all have to make. And to summarize, remember, the world is volatile. The only way you can reduce volatility is by having a vision. When you have a vision, then the world is uncertain, which has full of doubts. To be able to reduce the doubts, you have to clear your understanding. The world would understanding would have, when you get a lot of understanding, it would be a lot of more complexity in the world. The complexity is equal to it is difficult when you find difficulty understanding, it should be established by clarity. Ambiguity is simple when you can have multiple interpretation about the same thing, and this can only be managed through agility. This is all from my side, and thank you for patient listening. I understand we could not, but I think next set of questions would help us take us through. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Srivastava. I believe that this was one of the most useful sessions that our audience might have attended. Now, I would like to invite our director, Dr. Divya Chaudhary, to take some questions and to thank Mr. Srivastava.
Thank you, Dr. Naveen. Mr. Avnish, thank you for an awesome presentation. And in fact, pictorials were eye-catching and well-drawn. This topic, bright future ahead, I believe is silver lining and desire of every individual present. Unprecedented time today has made it more challenging due to recession, attrition, and layovers in the corporate sectors, industry, academy, and other job markets globally. I agree with you that there is a need of flexibility to students. In fact, learner centricity, which means there is availability of multiple entry and exit points for students. The potential of time, place, mode, technology, speed, and language should be factors and part of the new approach towards a brighter future. Without taking much time, as it is already, we are running a little late, I would like to take a few questions, and I have Divyanshi with me. Divyanshi, are you there to ask a question? Please introduce yourself and ask question.
Yes, ma'am. So good afternoon, present one and all over here. I am Divyanshi Jaiswal, pursuing BCom honors from Banaras Hindu University. Sir, it would be grateful if you share some tips for better communication and presentation in context to virtual communication.
See, don't make your life too difficult by getting bogged down by what you are hearing, as I mentioned in my presentation. See, communication is communication, whether virtual or in person doesn't make a much difference. The idea is you're using technology and you should be able to learn what technology is all about. So as we talked about having clarity, having been able to push those tools, the only gap between what is the virtual world and what is the real world is the skill. The problem with us, as most of us, is that we have not acquired right skills. Otherwise, nothing much has changed. Let me give an example to all of you. As was mentioning earlier, so if you ask the sales world today, what is happening, most of the people will come back and say that I'm not able to do sales, or it's more challenging to do sales in this real world is because I'm not able to meet clients. Now, if you define the complete sales process and break down into multiple pieces, meeting a client physically is only 10% or 5% of it. 95% of the activity that you do to get a sale is beyond meeting a client physically, right? So if you are good at 95% of the process, you will still get 95% results. I'm not denying the importance of physically meeting clients. At the same time, in the same world, before COVID, we also had online opportunities and sales. So how the same set of exercise with those people who had right skills could achieve a sales number? Let me give an example, very specific example of life insurance industry. We have agents who are manual people who directly meet the people to sell. And we also have web sales or online sales and telesales. So people do sell over the phone. People used to sell over internet. People sell and other mediums as well. That means meeting clients is only one way of selling. It is not the way to sell. Hence, and out of that way of selling, 95% of the process is beyond meeting people physically. I hope this answers your question. If I understood your question and answered it right.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
I also believe, Divyanshi, the doubt must be clear by now. I can see we have Shrishti with us. Shrishti, would you like to ask a question?
Yes, ma'am. So first of all, very good news to all and all present here. And my question is, sir, that you have asked about and telling us about the technology. So the question is based on that, has the development of internet and social media caused a change in the way we communicate, as in quality, quantity, and style, etc.?
Perfect. Now, thank you for raising this again. And if you had listened to this one of the sections that we were referring to in terms of ambiguity. Now, social media or all these platform of learning that you call as learning can also create a lot of ambiguity. Remember, ambiguity means when you can interpret the same thing in multiple ways. So the only problem that the only skill that is required again is your ability to interpret. Now, nobody can, for example, what I say today, you may have different rights of interpretation that you will take in your career. So interpretation can be a universal interpretation rules, which nobody can make, but we can also gain it by experiencing it. So social media and the available resources, if are backed by the responsibility of also educating how to use it, is a problem. The gap is about not being aware what is social media. So we know what is WhatsApp. We know what is Facebook. We know what is LinkedIn. But if we ask 10 questions to each other as a form of a quiz only on Facebook, only on LinkedIn, and only on for WhatsApp, we'll only get restricted to the exchange of thoughts. We get restricted to exchange of videos or messages. The world is much beyond that. So it is too less time to explain the complete concept, but I hope partially I've been able to address your question. So the key is to remain focused on what you want to achieve out of social media, shortlist what is good for you, shortlist what is your target audience, and decide an intervention frequency for it. Spending time in social media can be dangerous if it is not targeted with an objective. That is how I look at it. Thank you.
Very well answered, Avnish. Very well answered. And there are so many questions I can see, and I don't know which one to pick and which one to leave. I think I should go with one more question and then we should end this session because Mr. Jayanta is also waiting. Yeah. Alma, would you like to ask your question, please?
Yes, ma'am. So first of all, good afternoon to everyone. And thank you, sir, for this valuable session. It was, you know, a knowledgeable one. And my question is like how to communicate the problem faced in an organization related to its environment if it is creating work-life imbalance?
So you have actually heard, touched the sentiments of many people who are part of industry right now. First of all, the only problem is that we don't align the difference between the work and life. So there's something called timeline, there's something called lifeline. Now, if you try to draw both things very clearly, you'll be able to manage work-life balance. It is not the organization that decides your work-life balance. It is a myth. Aapka koi boss ya aapka koi bhi organization aapki life ko hit nahi kar sakta agar humko apne deliverables clear ho. For example, I can still achieve my KPIs, I can still deliver my results by balancing my 24 hours in a day. Let me give an example to you. How long do you think your bosses or your system can keep you captive, even in the work from home environment or in the physical environment? We decided as bad practitioners of employee understanding and capable thinking in terms of the mindset that we carry, that we get enslaved to the concept of long working hours. So long working hours and effective working hours. Please remember the first word, being effective and being efficient. Now, if you can't be efficient, nobody can help you. So work-life balance is the output of your self-development. It is the output about how do you, and hence, if you want to communicate to your seniors, you will be only able to communicate what is the demand and what is right and what is wrong and whatever communication they want to converse with. When you are very sure about maintaining your average minimum threshold of efficiency and effectiveness, if you are not at the minimum threshold of effectiveness and efficiency, you will always face the challenge of work-life balance. It may be a three-day working environment, three-day-a-week working environment, it may be a five-day-a-week working environment, it may not allow you to work from home. I think in all the situations, I will take one more minute to explain that because it's important. For example, many people in Bombay, the place that I reside right now, used to talk about spending multiple hours, 6 hours, 8 hours traveling. Now, even after the 6 or 8 hours have got reduced and people have started working from home 24/7, they still have a problem of work-life balance. Why? So you can understand from the example whether the answer only lies with your seniors and the industry within the company, or it somewhere lies within you and the way you manage your time in terms. So I'll be keen whenever to visit my website if you want to, whatnext.com. You'll get certain queries. You write back to me and we can be in touch to take this forward, because of possible time, I don't want to go further because this is a huge subject to discuss at length. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, Alma, correct. Thank you so much, Avnish. This seems to be a full basket session and must be appreciated by all. And we, on behalf of Jargon Institute of Management, thank you for sharing your time and valuable thoughts. Avnish, we would like you to kindly accept a certificate for your contribution and acknowledge it through an e-certificate.
Thank you, Mr. Srivastava.
Thank you,
Director Ma'am. Now it's time for our last speaker of the day. It's a pleasure to introduce Mr. Jayanta Chakravarti. As I go through his profile, I see that Mr. Chakravarti is a data analysis and technology expert. He is Chief Technology Officer at ESP Stats, a data science and analytics company. He holds a bachelor degree in mechanical engineering from NIT Agartala. He received his MBA degree from IMI Europe and MA in economics from Devi Ahilyabai University, Indore. He holds diploma in French and certification in German. He is also a SAP certified ERP consultant, IBM certified big data analyst, and Google certified AdWords professional. Mr. Chakravarti has certification in data mining from ISI Kolkata and ISI Bangalore. Certification in data analytics from IIT Madras and IIT Roorkee, and certification in e-business from IIT Kharagpur. He has more than 25 years of experience in steel, IT, and education sector. Mr. Chakravarti has executed strategic consulting projects for Coca-Cola, Colgate-Palmolive, Videocon, Akai, ICICI Bank, Punjab National Bank, DRDO, GES Australia, and many more reputed companies. He has a rich experience of working across many territories, such as Switzerland, England, and India. He has jointly conducted workshops with eminent experts from Harvard University, London Business School, INSEAD Paris, and IMD Lawson. Mr. Chakravarti has trained more than 5,000 professionals in Asia and Europe. He has authored books like Digital Marketing 2.0, HR Analytics, The Digital Entrepreneur, The Cinderella Jones Affair, and This is not all. Mr. Chakravarti has a long list of achievements. I cannot make our audience to wait anymore. So now I invite Mr. Chakravarti to take over the session. Mr. Chakravarti.
Thank you very much, Dr. Naveen. Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Okay. Thank you very much for giving the wonderful introduction. And for the last speaker is very challenging, actually, because many of the people would be looking at the watches, waiting for the lunch time. So what I'll do is I'll make it short and sweet. And the other thing is wise people say that the most valuable thing that you can give to anybody is time. Time is very valuable, more valuable than money. So you're giving me your precious time. So I'll also give you something valuable in return. So please stay on till the end. Already participants are reducing, but please don't go away because you'll be taking away a very valuable learning from this session that I can promise you in a short time. I would not take much of the time. Can you see the PPTs? Can you see the PPT?
Yes, it is visible.
Okay. So this is my introduction, which has been given by Dr. Naveen. So I'll very quickly skip. Apart from my technology and my industry experience, I have also been Dean of IIM Chandigarh, HOD of ICFA University, Chandigarh University, Graphicera University, Woxon University. So my career spans across industry, academics, and everything. And I work very closely with corporates. And the thing that I love to do is actually right now I've written books and all, but the thing that I love to do is incubating companies. I see a lot of young people and there are a lot of young people who are present in this forum. And there are many students and many young people who come to me and say that we want to become entrepreneur, but we don't have the money. We don't have the connections. We don't know how to get the customers. And what I tell them is, why don't you become a digital entrepreneur? And today, if you look during the pandemic also, we had 15 companies who have actually crossed a $1 billion valuations. We call them unicorns. Okay, and all the technology companies. Okay, so this is what I'm doing right now, very actively incubating companies like Easy Ration, Fresh Market, Gokter. They are competing against the Amazon and Flipkart and all, and they're doing very well. All of them are doing well. The common thing among them is all are technology oriented. So I want to ask a question in this forum. There are a lot of young students here. So I want to ask a question that what do you expect from teachers when you go into inside the classroom? If anybody can unmute and answer me this question, I would like to make it a little interactive. So any of the participants, if you can tell me, what do you expect from teachers when you enter the classroom? Yes, anyone? You can unmute yourself and answer. Am I audible?
Yes.
Okay. If somebody can answer this, what do you expect from teachers when you enter the classroom?
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
You see. So my name is Nishtha, and yeah. I'm pursuing my MBA from Jagan Institute of Management.
Okay.
So I want to answer this question that whenever we enter our classroom, we expect from our teachers that they will teach us something new. They will enhance our skills and they will clear our doubts, whatever we are having, we are doubts having in any of the topic, in any of particular field. That's it.
Okay. Now let me tell you a paradox. Today, there is another teacher who is very erudite and knows everything. That teacher is called Google. And Google knows more than, I have 25 years of experience, but Google knows more than me. And Google knows more than all the teachers. So I would like to slightly contradict your answer. And I'll tell you, I have also a long teaching experience. And when students are asked, okay, how much do you remember about the teacher who, what they taught? Okay, it's very little. But what they remember is how much the teacher cared about them. If I ask you that, who was your best teacher? Okay, my best teacher was my German teacher who taught me German. She used to come to the class and tell Heft zu, kuli weg, okay, which basically meant that close your book, okay, and throw out your pen and open your mind. Okay, she used to say that don't take notes in my class. Classroom is meant for interaction. Classroom is meant for ideation. Classroom is meant for debates. So I will not come and teach you from the textbooks. I will not write anything on the boards. We will have thorough interaction, and I really loved it. And I'm very fluent in German and French both. I speak 7 languages, but my best teacher is my French teacher. It's about the teacher who cares. Teacher who not only teaches, but teaches in a way, okay, that you remember the teaching for a long time. And today this has become a challenge. Okay, this has become a big challenge today. Last year, suddenly all of us had to move to the technology platform. It was a sudden that most of the schools, colleges, universities, they did not want to disrupt the learning. They immediately moved into the electronic platform. Many teachers were not ready for it. Many students were not ready for it. So the social distancing, lockdown, curfew, mobility, and the dependency on mobile and internet actually created a huge disruption in the studies. I can give you my practical example. My son was very good in maths, and this time he is in class 9th, but he scored only 60 marks, and I don't blame him. So he was telling that, Papa, whatever the teacher teaches, I don't understand. Okay, she suddenly comes on the internet and internet is going up and down. I hardly could understand. She teaches and she goes away. So that classroom touch that was prevalent, the bonding that used to be formed between the teacher and the student is very much missing in today's scenario. Challenges for students, I hope all of you will agree with me that what students have faced in last 1 year, first of all, expensive mobiles. There has been some students, unfortunately, they have committed suicide because their parents could not buy their mobile phones. So mobile, last year what happened is that I took away the mobile from my son. He was becoming a game addict. So I took away the mobile. And in January, I said, no more mobiles for you. So you go to school, you study, you concentrate on your studies. In the month of April, I gave him a very expensive mobile. I had no choice because without a good mobile, you can hardly attend the class. But giving the mobile is also not enough. The bandwidth is very limited. Okay, hardly you get 2 GB or something, you get 1 GB, 1.5 GB and 2 GB. Now you have to attend classes from 9 to 4 o'clock or 9 to 6 o'clock. If you have to attend classes, how do you do it? Limited bandwidth. Internet is unreliable. It goes up and down. Suddenly it gets cut. Students are complaining about headache, eye problems, depressions. Classroom is meant for fun. Classroom is meant for interaction, sports, games, a lot of projects, initiatives, everything gone. Today, what is happening? Today, teachers are looking at the screen and continuously talking. And many of the times I also see that students switch off their cameras and they move away. Okay, they don't even attend the class. It happens because there are problems from the student side also. And one more dangerous thing which has happened, of course, PUBG is banned, but there are a lot of alternatives to PUBG. And again, my own example I'll give you, my son is once again a game addict and I cannot prevent that. If I tell him stop the games, he asks me a question, Papa, I'll stop the game, but what do I do? Will you allow me to go out and play? I don't have an answer to that. Okay, so these are the challenges, if I say, from the student side. Teachers are also equally facing the problems. How do we engage the class? Okay, so in the classroom, we could do a lot of exercises, interactions. There are some students who don't speak, so we could interact with them. Some students who are very interactive, they answer very well. Now, how do we do that in an electronic platform? Talking continuously, staring at the screen takes a toll on the health of the teacher. Okay, it's a very difficult task. I also teach at many universities and all. I know practically what is the pain that teachers go through. How do we do practical exercises, especially computers, engineering, medical? How do we teach through computers, through internet platform? Extremely difficult task. And again, the same problem, internet is unreliable. Every time, every 5 minutes, I have to ask, are you hearing my voice? Can you hear me? Can you see the slide? Okay, is the slide visible? Most of the time you'll see this is going on. Then there is a background disturbance. Okay, sometimes some student would switch on the voice and there would be some talking going on, or sometimes the teachers also, somebody will come behind and talk something. Okay, so, and sometimes it happens that a vehicle is going by. Okay, biggest problem I face is that my wife is also a professor. So when both of us teach, okay, then we disturb each other. Sometimes my wife says, you keep quiet. Sometimes I say, you keep quiet. So it's a family problem which starts in our house. Okay, so it's a challenge from both sides, from the teacher's side, from the student side. We have been facing n number of problems. So what is the solution to that? Okay, how have these schools, colleges, and universities adapted over the time? And you must be hearing that, of course, the corona cases are coming down. But does that mean that we will come back to classes very soon? I really doubt it, because the scientists are talking about a third wave, and the third wave might be affecting the children. So are we going to come back to the classroom? There is a very big question mark. Biggest question mark today is whether CBSE exams will be held or not, or how will they hold the exams? Okay, so a lot of discussions and a lot of strategies are being worked out, but Corona doesn't seem to be stopping. What I understand, my personal understanding about this is that this is a defining moment. This is a defining moment because we moved to the electronic platform and we are going to stay in the electronic platform. Even UGC, ICT, and Ministry of Education is talking about blended learning. They are saying that you cannot force a student to come to the classroom. If somebody is not coming, then you have to give them some kind of access so that the learning does not get affected. Okay, so everybody is now talking about blended learning. They are talking about LMS. Okay, so I'll touch a bit upon that in today's session. So we are talking about e-learning, which has become very big. Today there are companies like Baiju, companies like Upgrade, companies like Coursera. Okay, and I can name some 50-100 companies which are called EdTech. These are educational technology companies. And people were not very comfortable, because I find most of the students are comfortable when they are sitting with the teacher and interacting directly with the teacher. Students are more comfortable interacting directly. not through electronic platform, but now it has become there's no choice. Okay, it has become a compulsion that you have to interact. And this is very nicely being done by Baiju, Upgrad, Coursera, EDX, and all that. They have been doing it very nicely to create that environment which almost simulates a classroom, which gives that kind of feeling to you, which gives the kind of comfort. And it is also helping in a big way. So what is this LMS? So my topic was about what are the digital tools being used in teaching learning. So what is being used today is LMS, learning management system. So what is this LMS? Now this LMS has got the course design, course materials, everything which is created by the teacher is fed into the LMS. Now normal teaching system is that the teacher comes with the textbook and students also learn from the textbook, chapter by chapter it is covered, and then there are half yearly final exams and students score some marks and they progress to the next session. This was the normal system of learning. LMS has changed that. So LMS, what is happening is now you no longer have to carry the textbook. All the learning and everything is embedded within the LMS. You can just log into the LMS and you can, and there is a flexi system. You want to learn, do some advanced learning. Yes, you can do that. You want to do some preliminary learning. You want to go back forward. You can do everything. Teacher also takes helps of the LMS. It helps a lot because every time I don't have to look, where is my PPT? Where is that video I wanted to show? Okay, where is that chapter I wanted to refer? I don't need to search. Everything is embedded within the LMS. And students can do a lot of group activities also, like you used to do in the classrooms. That can also be done in the LMS. You can do a personal learning. Suppose you have missed a class, so that video lectures are uploaded. So in your leisure time, you can come back and you can attend the classes. Online materials are there. E-books are there. So you don't have to carry that big bag of books to the classroom. You don't have to carry. So you can always refer to e-books, learning materials, and everything is there in the LMS. So who is providing the LMS? There are three big companies who are doing it. One is Blackboard, the other is Moodle, the other is Canvas. Although many of the institutions till today are using Google Classrooms, or they're using Zoom and others, but many of the universities have now shifted over to Blackboard, Moodle, Canvas. These are the LMS which gives a complete learning, and they're slowly trying to simulate that classroom environment where the student and the teacher both feel comfortable and they get that ambience of a classroom. So Blackboard is a proprietary, is very expensive. It's an America-based company, and there is a license fee which has to be paid every year. And it has been used in very top universities are using today, many of the top universities. Many of the mid-tier and smaller institutions and schools using Moodle gives a lot of flexibility. So you can customize your learning. Okay, and most of the things in Moodle is free. So you can compare it like your Microsoft operating system and Android. So Blackboard is robust. Blackboard is very good. Blackboard is expensive. Moodle is most of the things are free. It can be customized. It can be taken off the shelf and it can be used. What is there in an LMS? As I showed in the diagram before, all the resources are there in LMS. Lessons modules are there in LMS. Assignments are there in LMS. The calendar is there, your class routine, when is the class supposed to happen. And you get alerts also that your class is going to start in next 15 minutes. Blogs are there, written by students and faculties both. You can chat. You can chat with your teacher. You can chat with your other students. There are forums where you can discuss. You can do messaging. You can message something you didn't understand. You can message to the teacher. There are wikis, there are quiz, there are questionnaires. There are all progress reports. So you want to download your progress report, you can do it from the LMS. So all these things are present in the LMS. So what I teach personally, and I think a lot of MBA students are there, so it might be interesting, is digital marketing. Now, let me share something interesting with you. I wrote a book called Digital Marketing 2.0. Why I wrote this book is that many of the companies with whom I do consulting, they came and complained that, sir, we are doing digital marketing, we are not getting any results. And I realized that when we talk about digital marketing, everybody is doing SEO, SEM, SMM, which are very traditional, and you don't get results. So what are these tools which really give you results? So I did a lot of research and I wrote a book, which is called Digital Marketing 2.0. And I do a lot of consulting also on this field, where I tell the companies that how can you differentiate yourself using digital marketing 2.0. But when I wrote the book, the publishers were not very interested to publish the book. They said, sir, by the time we publish this book, digital marketing 3.0 will come, 4.0 will come. So your book will become obsolete. So when I teach digital marketing, I tell my students, don't read any books. Don't read my book also. Okay. Although I'm not very keen to sell my book, I've just published it so that if somebody is interested can read, but I don't ask anybody to read my book. When I teach digital marketing, I use the LMS. So I'll practically show you the LMS, how I teach, and it might be helpful to the students and teachers both. Just give me a minute. Technology is a very big challenge. Anyway. So can you all see Skillshop on the screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
What I'll ask the students, you can take a photo shot of this with your cameras, with your mobile cameras. You can take a picture of this. Those who are interested to learn digital marketing, especially, I'll tell you, take a picture of this. This will help you a lot. Okay, so I told you that Google knows more than any teacher present in this forum, or I have 25 years of experience, but Google knows more than that. So when I teach digital marketing, I teach it through this LMS. So what is this LMS? LMS has got here, you can see, it has got topics. Okay, what do you want to learn? So you say that I want to learn how to make Google ads. Okay, I want to do how to. So what do you want to do? Do you want to do certifications also? You can click the certification thing and it will take you to this screen. Okay, where there are a lot of certifications. So one of the certifications, what I want students, you can do it. If you are looking for good jobs and all in digital marketing, you can see on your screen, there is something called Google AdSearch certification. If you can do this AdSearch certification and if you can put it in your CV, okay, chances are you will get very good jobs. Today, most of the jobs are actually in digital marketing, artificial intelligence, machine learning, big data, IoT. Okay, this is where most of the jobs are coming, even for MBA students and technology students both. So suppose you do this certification, you might actually get good jobs. So here you can click. And you don't have to go anywhere. You don't have to read any textbook or something. Just click here and you will see Google AdSearch certification. Now, when you come down saying get started, don't click here. Don't click on get started because it will start an exam. There is some pointers here which says grow your business with Google Ads 15 minutes. Explore the value of Google search 32 minutes. Understand Google Ads auction 11 minutes. Okay, so how to actually, this is what most of the companies come to me and say, and last year I've done a lot of consulting with digital because most of the companies came to me and say, sir, our business is closed. Government won't allow us to open the shops. So we have to go digital, but how do we go? Can you help us to go digital? So if somebody comes to you and says, ask the same question, can you please help me to go digital? This is the answer. Okay, the answer lies here. How do you promote your business using Google Ads? So you can just click here, this is written 15 minutes. And it is saying resume because I was going through it. So it is saying resume for you, it will say get started or something. So you can click here. And so for students, I'll tell you that you just take a screenshot of this. Okay, it will help you. So get to know Google Ads. So click on view, get to know Google Ads. And you will see here, there are a lot of learnings. Okay, knowledge check. So learnings are here. What is the relevance? You click here, more lessons will come. How to control, lessons will come. Click on the arrow.
And what's lessons will come.
Yes. Can you please mute? Okay. And after you have done the lessons, all these lessons are 15 minutes, 15 minutes. Now, I told you what happens in the digital platform. If I give a lecture for 2 hours, okay, many students will close the camera and go away. Okay, so these are all 15 minutes lecture. And after 15 minutes, there is a question here. Okay, so they will ask you a question. You are a brand manager with e-commerce retail company. You are looking to advertise online and measure the volume of sales coming from your digital campaigns. Which of the following benefits of Google Ads could help you to accomplish? Okay, now whether you have got the learning or not, you can understand through that. Okay, so maybe I click on this and I submit the answer. And they say it's right. The answer is correct. If you have given the wrong answer, then it will say the answer is wrong. And this is how you can do the learning using an LMS. So I hope everybody has taken a screenshot. Those who are interested in digital marketing or you want to build skills in digital marketing, which are of great value in today's market, because I'm telling you, every company is today asking for digital marketing experts. Even Big Bazaar and your Reliance and more, all these stores have also moved digital today. They are also closed, okay, but they are supplying products. Okay, and Amazon, Flipkart, Snapdeal is doing great business. Big Basket is doing great business. Okay, so all the traditional companies are now trying to move into the digital space. So those MBA students who are present in this platform, in this forum, it's my strong advice to you that please go to this forum and pick up digital skills. If you can do that, great. Okay, you can build a career, you can get very good jobs. Okay, so this is about Google LMS. Plus one thing, what is happening, how teaching learning has changed today, is something called a flipped classroom. Okay, what is a flipped classroom? Normally the teacher used to come and say, okay, today I'll be teaching you chapter number 7. Okay, so chapter number 7, let me brand positioning. So let me say, what is brand positioning? Then I'll tell you how brand positioning is done and I'll complete the chapter. And then I'll give you an assignment and I'll go away. This is the normal way the teacher teaches. Today in electronic platform, it is not done that way. What is being done is you are given the material. The study material is given before. Today, chapter 7 will be done. All the content of chapter 7 is there in that LMS. You are supposed to log in through the LMS and read the chapter 7. I will not discuss chapter 7 in the class. What I'll do in the class is we will do an interactive exercise. Okay, now you have to tell me, how do you use brand positioning to grow the brand equity of a company, or grow the profitability of the company, or grow the sales of the company? So I'll make groups and I'll give you the assignment, and the students have to make the presentations. This is how today teaching is happening. Okay, and your Zoom and all, they have got breakout rooms. Some of the teachers might be using those features, breakout rooms. And also in breakout rooms, we divide the groups, we give them the task, and then we again assemble the group. The students give the presentation, and there is a very healthy kind of thing. The classroom very interesting, rather than teacher coming and reading out from page number 1 to page number 10. That is not very interesting. So this is what we are doing in today's context, the flipped classroom. Best practices, see what I showed you in Google right now. If I talk continuously for 2 hours, people will not understand anything. Our human being attention span is 15 minutes. So normally universities and schools and all, they give a lecture hour of 1 hour, 1.5 hour, 2 hours, but students do not understand anything. Their attention span is only 15 minutes. So in digital learning, what we are doing now, Coursera, edX, even Google, I showed you what everybody is doing. The lecture is 15 minutes. After 15 minutes, it's an activity. Another interesting, and then there are MCQs and assignments are there. Another interesting thing that is being done in today's context is storytelling. It is gaining in importance lots. Even my students whom I have taught 20 years back or 15 years back, I have taught them. When I meet them in airports or railway stations, I ask them, do you still remember my teaching? They say, no, sir, we have forgotten everything what you have taught us. But we have not forgotten those stories. We used to tell a lot of stories about Coca-Cola, Colgate, Palmolive, and these brands, paper boat and all, how these brands grew, what they did, what strategies they used. Used to tell a lot of stories in the class. We still remember those stories. So how to engage the students in the classrooms? Today's good teachers are using this storytelling technique. And students stay in the class, they listen, and it's a lot of interactive. The last challenge is how to take exams. Today there is a debate going on CBSE, what to do with CBSE. If you call the students and take the exams, the children will get affected with corona. And third wave, people are very afraid. It is going to affect the children. Children are not vaccinated. So what do we do about the children? Should we call them to a room and ask them to take exams? Should we scrap the exams? Should we take an average? There's a lot of debate. Now IIT Goa, they have come out with a very interesting thing. I hope you can see on the screen. Okay, it's a 3 hours exam. There are only two questions. Only two questions. Question number one is prepare the question of 60 marks from the lecture material provided to you in the entire semester, lecture 1 to lecture 30. It should reflect your understanding about the course and also must be answered in 2 hours. Avoid discussing with your friends. It may reduce your score if similarities are found. 30 marks. And answer the questions you prepared, 40 marks, 70 marks. So very interesting way IIT Goa is taking the exam. IIT Goa is asking the student that you make the question and you answer the question. Now the students who have really studied, now here you cannot do any kind of corruption or you cannot use those Munna Bhai tricks. This is possible. Okay, if you have genuinely studied all the 30 lessons, only then you can make a good question and you can give the answer also. So people, normally again, I'll tell you what happens. Many of the students, when I used to teach, many of the students used to come and say, sir, we cannot read the whole book. Tell us which chapter is important or which paragraph is important. Give us some important topics. Okay, to study on important topics. Now that is not a very good way of learning. Okay, so sometimes there is a joke that patient goes to doctor and says, I have a problem in my ear. So doctor says, sorry, in our times, ear was not an important topic. I know about the nose only. Okay, so this kind of problems happen because students have studied only important topics. But here, IIT Goa, what they have done is they've used a very interesting methodology where the students who have genuinely studied all the 30 topics, only then they will score well. Okay, so there are a lot of innovations like this, what is happening. I promised I'll make it short and sweet. It's lunchtime. Okay, so that's all from my side. And I hope I've given you something valuable which justifies the time that you have invested in this session. Thank you very much, everyone. And if you have got any questions, I would love to take.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chakravarti, for sharing your expertise. Hope this session was a great learning experience for our audience. Now, I would like to invite Dr. Divya Chaudhary, Director, Jagran Institute of Management, to take some of the questions and thank Mr. Chakravarti.
Thank you, Dr. Naveen. First of all, a very good afternoon, Mr. Jayanta, and thank you for a wonderful session. As we understand, it's lunchtime, but your session was so full that I don't think so anybody would like to miss even a single blink, because it was such a well-packed session on specifically on teaching learning technology. And it actually well highlighted that technology is a critical element in the whole process. The new teaching learning will be backed by adequate technology and obviously blended modes of acquiring knowledge also. Though there are many teaching methods and techniques, available resources indicate that blended learning mode is the best of all in the world. And this is what the time also says. So without taking much time, I would like to take a few questions. I have Akansha Goswami with me. Akansha, are you there to ask the question, please?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you, Divya, ma'am. Good afternoon, sir. And good afternoon to all who have joined this webinar. Sir, my name is Akansha Goswami and I'm doing BSc Mathematics from Deen Dayal Upadhyay University. Sir, as in this era, we know communication is fundamental to the existence and survival of humans as well as to any organizations, but we always categorize the things. So, sir, my question is, what are the greatest challenges to good communication?
I'll tell you, to become a good communicator, first thing that you need is you have to be a good listener. Okay, so I'll give you an example. The other day I was watching a video of Andre Agassi. Andre Agassi and Boris Becker were two great tennis players during my time. And Andre Agassi always used to beat Boris Becker. So after many years, both of them retired. So Boris Becker asked Andre Agassi that how did you manage to beat me every time? So Andre Agassi said, Boris, you have got a very peculiar thing. You stick your tongue out. Okay, when you're sticking your tongue out in the left side, I know you are going to serve from the left. When you're sticking out your tongue in the right side, I know you are going to serve from the right and I get ready accordingly. So what is Andre Agassi doing? He's a great observer, and that is why he was a great champion. And that is what I'll tell Akansha about communication. To become a good communicator, become a good listener first. Okay, so understand why or who is whom are you talking to? Understand the context. Okay, and when you are speaking to the context, people will be interested to listen to you. Many a times we get flowed and we start talking sometimes we talk nonsense also, we go out of the context. Number three is the scenario. Where are you communicating? What environment also plays a key role when we communicate, because if it is a very serious environment and if you start cracking jokes, it doesn't look good, okay, in a scientific forum or something. But it's a forum where, yes, you can do some lighthearted talk also, case studies and all. Great, go ahead and do it. So you have to understand what environment are we talking. Number four is the medium. What is the medium I'm using to communicate? Face-to-face communication, different. Electronic communication, different methodology has to be used. So we have to, these are the four things that I would say that you have to be very keen when you are communicating. The first and the foremost important is be a good listener. Be a person with empathy. Understand the other person to whom you are speaking and speak in context. Great, people will take your message.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much, sir.
Welcome. Any other questions?
Thank you, Akansha. Thank you, Mr. Jayanta. I think Akansha question is very well answered. I can see I have another student, Archie. Archie, are you here to ask your question, please?
Yes. Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon to everyone.
Good afternoon.
I'm Archie Singhania, pursuing MBA from Jagran Institute of Management. So, sir, my question to you is that how to bring powerful impact on listeners?
Okay, how to bring a powerful impact on listeners? Again, the first and most important point is do a research. Okay, who is your listener? Okay, what is the kind of people you are addressing to? So is it a student group? Is it a professional group? And all that. Okay, so do a first of all, do a research on your participants. Number two, do a good research on the topic. Okay, whatever you are speaking, again, has to be within the context. So research is the most important thing before you think about making the impact. So impromptu talks when we give sometimes does not make the impact. But when I'm ready with what I'm going to speak, okay, when I'm well prepared, that makes the real kind of impact. Number three, okay, when the audiences come to listen to you, you have to say something which the audience does not know. Okay, now here also, if you have seen, my presentation was embanking on Google technology and digital marketing. Okay, something I wanted to give valuable, which there are a lot of students in this forum, which can they can take home as value. Okay, so focus on that value. Okay, what I'm delivering, is it creating some kind of value among the listeners? They will appreciate a lot. So these are the two important things I'll say. Research on your audience, research on the topic, and see that you are delivering something of value. If these three conditions are fulfilled, yes, your impact will be great.
Thank you so much, sir.
Welcome.
Right, well answered. I think it's a session full of insights, and highlighting digital tools specifically will certainly will increase student engagement and learning. Mr. Jayanta, since I was just thinking, there is one question in my mind also. Can I please?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. This we all have been discussing a lot among our different faculty members and in home also. But I would like to listen to your opinion that how can we improve the attention span during the webinars and meetings, which we are conducting virtually these days?
Yeah. Now, ma'am, again, I'd like to share with you, there is NPTEL and there is Coursera. Now, if you have gone through that, NPTEL, what the faculty members are from IITs and all, they deliver a lecture of 1.5 hours without stopping. And it's very difficult to attend those lectures. Now, if you come to Coursera, it is different. It is 15 minutes and then there is an exercise and then there is some interaction and then again 15 minutes. Okay. So what I said in my presentation also, you have to understand the attention span. In the classroom, still it is very easy to engage the students with case studies and all that. But electronically, it's a very big challenge. If I'm talking continuously for 1 hour, students will switch off and run away. Okay, so it has to be a lot of interactions. Now, how do I do the interactions in the online? That is the challenge. So it has to be 15 minutes. Break your lectures into small 15 minutes each. And in between, you put these interactions, which Zoom has a feature called breakout groups, and Blackboard also has it. Google, I'm not sure whether they have it. So this kind of features are there where you can do the breakouts. In between also we can put some kind of quizzes, some kind of videos. Now, one of the advantage we are getting in this online learning, we can use a lot of videos. Okay, that is possible. Yeah. So put some kind of videos, put some kind of exercises, some kind of quiz, and make it a package. The one to be a package, like today, again, what happens is people are not going to move and we don't have the patience to watch.
Exactly.
That if you are given a choice, will you make DDLJ once again? So he said, no. These young people will not go to the theater and watch for 3 hours. I'll make a web series. Okay.
Yes.
So today's young people are this 15 minutes audience. Certainly. This is what I'll tell you. Okay, you make it into a package of 1 hour where there is a lecture, there is exercise, interaction, presentation. So make it a complete package and then people will be engaged.
Brilliantly answered. I think all my faculties and other teachers also listening on this platform would appreciate your answer, because somewhere we all know, but we actually need to know how to put every bead in the string together to make a complete one note. Thank you so much. Thank you for your time, valuable time also. And kindly acknowledge on behalf of Jagran Institute of Management a small token of thanks and appreciation with this e-certificate. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Mr. Srivastava. I must say that even I learned many new things from this webinar. I would like to thank our director, Dr. Divya Chaudhary, for inviting such eminent speakers and organizing this webinar. I would also like to thank our audience for being such a wonderful audience. Hope to meet you all in another such session very soon. Goodbye. Jai Hind.